I just realized I forgot to turn the mic on again. It's the second time today.
Well, we got it in time this time. We'll be dropping some sweet casts of these finals. Two teams making it in. Silent Gaming and Good Luck Jonathan. Gonna be, I think, one of the more interesting matches. I don't believe we've seen these two teams square off yet. This is actually all unprecedented, uncharted territory here.
Yeah, this is all new. I'm really excited to see how it goes. Theoretically, these boys should be starting up the game here soon. They did start in separate groups, so that means this is uncharted territory for us in terms of watching these teams play.
Yep. Looking like Silent could possibly be the stronger of these two teams. They ban out Kindred, taking that away from Red Panda off the bat. They had a little bit of an advantage. Their series in the semifinals only went two games, whereas the series for Good Luck Jonathan against Dank Memers went to that third game, and they were able to kind of get a good look at everything they did in that third game we just spec'd here on the screen.
Apparently, they scrimmed these guys before the tournament.
They're dumb.
Stupid. This is dumb.
Silent Gaming, you're stupid.
You mean nothing to us?
They hear us. They're obviously listening.
Mean nothing to us. Pre-tournament is irrelevant. That's right.
Yeah. Huh? Who won pre-tournament? Who won the
scrims? Who did win pre-tournament? Who won? Them, right? GG.
Damn, they're not telling you. Silent Gaming, sticking true to their name.
They don't say that they lost.
Yeah, that's right. If you don't tell us, you lost. Moving on, we do see some quick bans coming out. Kindred, Poppy, Mundo coming out from the side of Silent Gaming. Vayne, Shen, Jax coming out on the side of Good Luck Jonathan.
Good Luck Jonathan. I know, it's been slipping me all time. This is a tougher one. Ezreal, obviously priority pick, played by Parthigen and Horcrux Maximus. And Lamps. They obviously took away Lamps and Vayne this time. Didn't want him having that one. Didn't want to let that one slide right on through. So
we did get some secret information about that Ezreal, though. The reason Lamps has been wanting to play it so much is because Silent Rain gifted him the Pulsefire Ezreal skin last night for playing so well.
Mm.
That's $20. What a teammate. Kyle, looking at you. Kind of. What?
I don't have $20.
Yeah, yo, me either. We're looking at the Alistar and Kalista pick coming out here for the side of Good Luck Jonathan. That is a strong combo that we've seen one or two times, but it looks like they're going to go with the jungler and the support instead.
Yeah, prioritizing that Elise, trying to take away one of the more aggressive junglers for Lamps, and maybe somebody that, Dingus. Maybe somebody that, if Dingus did opt to go for that Vi again in this instance, they could really have some counterplay available. Mm-hmm. Maokai being hovered. First time we would have seen him all tournament, I believe.
Yeah. I mean, Maokai is one of those champions that we have seen. We've seen Silent Rain play Maokai before in that Georgia Tech tournament a couple weeks ago.
Yep.
And he's pretty good on him. I don't really know how Maokai plays out in this patch with the recent Keystone Masteries and everything.
Sure.
It'll be interesting to see, that's for sure. He's definitely not Flavor of the Month anymore in LCS, though.
No, not... Not like Worlds, where he's somewhere always in meta.
Yeah, that was weird.
The Thresh pickup as well, pretty safe, but standard when they reveal the Alistar, it's okay then to go ahead and pick up your support, as you're not giving away any potential counter pick information. Peeking at that lane. The Morgana, not surprised at all to see this as a priority for Parthigen. If he didn't pick it up, or it could be... No. It's definitely Parthigen then, if they lock that in. I wouldn't be surprised yet to see Moon pick it up. He does not have his comfortable last pick in mid just yet, so we're actually going to get to see...
Rammus hover?
Rammus the Slammus. We'll see it.
I really kind of want to see a Rammus, and if it's Rammus, I want it to be Rammus mid.
My feelings about Rammus are pretty mixed. Like, he's not...
He's not great.
Phenomenal. He's not bad. He's really just, like, okay.
I feel like Rammus would do relatively well against Jinx because he's got that built-in Thornmail and just sit there and bounce those auto attacks right off there.
Yeah.
But I don't actually play Rammus. If we see Darius come out again, I'm going to be very surprised.
The Darius was kind of instrumental in the one game that Silent came so terribly close to losing.
Yeah, the early game impact was super weak. It didn't start until the game started to come back.
True. You gonna say Rocket Med? You gonna do it, Moon?
Lock it in. Lock it in.
Dare you.
Lock it in.
Double dog.
Lock it in. I've
been dared.
If we had more spectators, I would make them start chanting. Lock it in. Lock it in. Lock it in.
We tried.
Oh, he's going to do it.
What? Zillion. Can't kill you in the zillion. That's zillion mid.
I've been trolled.
Little pocket pickup.
Yeah, we actually do have a little bit of a possible flex pick between the Maokai and the Pantheon. They can either go top or in the jungle. Maokai jungle has been a thing before.
Yeah.
It could be a thing now. The secret silent gaming strats, man.
Speaking of secret silent gaming strats, triple S's, no one seems to be running teleport just yet. Rain with that ignite as well as Moon. Not the worst thing in the world if you're, you know, having some global impact from the Pantheon.
Yeah.
But in this instance, it looks like Good Luck Jonathan may be looking for a double teleport instance.
Yeah.
Silent Gaming would be putting themselves at a disadvantage if they don't swap anything over. I don't think they're probably ghosting the stream, so I'm sure they definitely can tell the summoners on the other side, but it really shouldn't be revealing the summoners on the other side. Yeah, Silent Moon, switching to the teleport at a very convenient time, Moon.
We're looking at you, Moon.
Real original thought process.
Moon. I will say, in terms of Good Luck Jonathan's comp, they do not have that much damage again.
Yeah, that is true.
In terms of straight up damage, there's no burst damage. They want really long peeled out fights, mm-hmm. I think, which is kind of counterintuitive to what the Malphite does.
That is true. Yeah, Malphite slam it right in. Really surprised Parthogen didn't maybe want an Orianna with the Malphite and the Alistar going in, but obviously he thought it best to prioritize taking away that Morgana. Didn't want to face it against Moon.
Yeah.
He has been coming in clutch with it.
I'm interested to see how Silent Moon Zillion does. They do have that passive change on him where he can give experience to other team members. Mm-hmm. So he does have that going for him, which actually is pretty neat because he can, you know, if the jungler gets behind, throw some experience on the jungler.
Yeah.
AD carry gets behind, throw some experience on the AD carry.
Yeah, really equalize a good bit of level pressure.
Yeah.
If the Ezreal does fall behind, Jinx, Alistar probably shouldn't be putting Ezreal Thresh too far behind in lane.
Yeah.
If that's going to happen anywhere, I would actually see it happening in the mid lane. That's the thing, is I don't, maybe jungle too, with Elise coming in a little bit. You were right on this side, it is the Maokai jungle and not the Pantheon jungle.
Yep.
So Maokai will be jungling. That's probably where they'll get the furthest behind, is mm-hmm. Maokai against the Elise.
Yep.
Whereas, you know, Ezreal Thresh really shouldn't lose. Definitely Pantheon should be winning against Ghost of Bomb, especially if he elects to pull that Ignite in. Silent Rain, once more.
Yeah, I'm seeing a whole another Rich Homie Drake situation here with this Malphite Pantheon again. It makes me wonder if Gosu T-Bomb saw that game and was just like, I can do this better. This is good.
Quite possibly.
This is something I can do. This is things. Oh, my. Oh, hey, Mitch. Jonathan says hi. I got baited.
What happened?
Trolled. Jonathan texted a group message I was in, and he told me to say hi to Mitch. Dude, okay, see, I wasn't clued into that, all right? See, trolled. Oh, see. Yeah, so right now there's really not much to say about these comps. They're pretty straightforward in what they're trying to do. You said the Elise and Maokai, he is going to get farther behind. It'll be interesting to see if Elise does try to do any early game pressure mm-hmm. invade. I know that Good Luck Jonathan has done a little bit of those cheesy strats before where they walk in, do a little something-something, and walk out. So, mm-hmm.
I think if the game goes late, that's over in the hands of Good Luck Jonathan, but Silence composition is so well picked in terms of not ever letting it get late.
Yeah. There's a lot of siege. There's tons of siege there.
Yeah. There's just so much potential to stop this not even snowball, but scaling dead in its tracks before it really gets a chance to get anywhere terribly severe.
Exactly.
Who's comp? Purple's comp.
You see, like purple
you know what?
More?
We've been saying that against literally every single team composition that Silent has played. This is the third time it comes around that Silent drafts a team composition that is unconventional, but then they make work. It really falls down to a lot of the individual skill that these guys employ.
Yeah, it's very, very weird.
Yeah.
It is weird. I mean, it's like one of those things, like, you see a team comp and you're like, this should definitely not work.
No, I know it. But
and then it does.
Silent are the ones making it work. It was especially prevalent in that one match, the first in their best of series against Lucky and the Wards.
Yeah.
Where Lucky and the Wards had the, on paper, better comp, and for much time started playing it better, too. Just couldn't get that turnaround. But we are loading into the first match of the Grand Finals for the Kennesaw State University League of Legends Winter Classic 2016. Blood and tears will be shed. Probably not sweat, because this is esports.
Yeah, we did point out earlier in the stream that Treadmaster does have that Black Alistair skin, which is a pre-order bonus from the original release of League of Legends. Yes, that is correct.
This means... Treadmaster.
Two different ones, but the collector's edition is not available anymore. It got discontinued after a year.
Oh, okay. Let's just all take a step back to reflect on the fact that plenty of people pre-ordered a free-to-play game.
Hey, listen, I pre-ordered Blade and Soul that just came out a couple days ago, right? That's free-to-play.
That's the same thing. I got trolled, man.
You did get trolled. Speaking of trolling, looks like we're on a little bit of a collision course here. On the bot lane, two teams running at each other.
Oh, this is what I'm talking about.
Hopefully they won't spot each other out before it's too late for some action. Maybe actually even going to miss one another. Neither team has seen the other. Jinx trailing on the back line there actually could be in trouble. Oh, no. This is so great. Neither of them has any idea. Silent, though.
Silent's going to get caught first if they cut through the river there.
That's true. Yeah, they're going to know. This is it. And who's in the front? It is. Is Zillion caught up? There it is, the level one 5v5. Zillion flashing out, and he's gonna go down. First blood for the Elise. The action is still continuing as Silent Wolfaroo is in trouble. Ghosty T-Bomb also having to back off of that one as they're trying to chase, but running back toward the tower. And it looks like it's actually just gonna be the Summoner Flurry coming out, and maybe the re-engage from Silent. Do they want it, Dingus? I do not know. I do not think so. The 1-4-0, 500 gold in the lead with the first blood coming to the Elise.
It was a really good gank and a really strong play.
That is not the one you want to give it to early. Oh no. Elise, the jungler, the one responsible for snowballing all of the lanes and having some heavy ganks.
It's very, very bad.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, we're going to close this real fast. I need to change the... Yeah, here we go. Audio.
All right. Strong side starts for both of these teams. Silent Dingus on that Maokai coming out, getting a little bit of that delay on the golems. Elisa's definitely going to be at her buff first, and with that spider clear time, actually should be in a position to do so much more quickly. The first death falling onto Zillion, not going to delay him getting to lane, actually, is still neatly enough trade and find experience-wise with that Morgana. So all of that well and good squared away. We're going to really see now the game has fallen upon Red Panderp's shoulders. It's his job to turn this into something now. He's gotten the kill. His lanes are expected to do well, maybe go even. But where can he now turn this in? Because if he just, you know, jungles this all away, he's wasting this advantage that his team has given him.
Yeah. Right now, there's actually a lot of places that Panderp can go. There was a lot of flashes burned during that last fight. Oh, wow.
Speaking of flashes, Silent Dingus flashing in onto Parthage, and he does not have flash as he flashed away from the first fight. So there is that first blood. No, almost. Yes, it does happen. We were baited a little bit there.
Oh, good.
Very
hook.
Close. Great hook onto Horcrux Maximus as well. Treadmaster has a lot of that peel, though. With that level 2, Alistair already just able to bail Jinx out from some very sticky situations, and Treadmaster is having to back right on off of that one. So lanes are definitely out and in favor now of Silent off the bat. Gold's still even, but just the trading damage alone tells a huge story. Over on the side of... there's another hook on the Treadmaster. The play back. The Ezreal Q actually does not connect. It looks like Elise is coming up into the top lane. Silent Rain may be in trouble. He does have a big wave, but very, very little mana here. He's trying to hide behind the wave. Actually, as someone does use it for the teleport, that's going to be Silent Moon coming up. But really, all you've done is waste the teleport at that point.
Yeah, it was too late for him to come up.
It was a bailout, but that's a pretty big question of whether or not that summoner is worth just saving Pantheon's life. When Pantheon actually may have been able to get a return kill onto Gosu Bomb. If he needed to.
Yeah. I think Panderp is going to have to start ganking these lanes a lot more. As you can see, Pantheon doesn't have his flash. Silent Moon doesn't have his flash. Ezreal doesn't have his heal. There's a lot of places.
So few summoners across the board.
Yeah, there's a lot of places that Panderp can go to take advantage of those moon splashes, especially based upon the strength of their level 1 gank.
Yeah. And again, Panderp really just let this one kind of slip away. It's a 1-for-1 in terms of kills. But the gank came out so quickly from Maokai, actually the least aggressive of these two junglers.
Yeah,
the less.
Yeah.
Imperative, not superlative.
The flash route was really, really fast. Morgana didn't have a chance to even Black Shield herself. And
well, she was level 2. She didn't have the Black Shield yet.
Oh, that's right. She took the Binding Torment and Soil. So she didn't even have it. That was a great gank. Silent Moon getting the stun out almost instantly right after the route came off.
Absolutely. Here comes Elise, though. Maybe looking for the counter gank. She should get spotted out by Malka here. Not any pings coming out, so Dingus may have let this one slip underneath his nose of Red Panther. No, there's no way. Dingus knows. He's going in. He wants that. Did he smite it? Who smite that? It doesn't matter. Red Panther got the smite. Also got the fight, maybe, that he wasn't looking for. Trying to get out of this one. That is Elise. Has a good potential for survival, but no flash. Oh, the Zillion Bomb. That may just do it. I think it will at that point, yeah. Morgana was so close to range for Black Shielding, too.
Yeah, it was so close. Just missing it. That was a really good last auto attack by Silent Moon there, actually. If you didn't get that last auto attack, and if Dingus didn't get that final little tree bomb.
Oh, I know it. Yeah, there was just such a chance that he could have lived through that and just didn't.
A little bit of aggression up here in the top lane. Both of them have already gone back, but Silent Rain does have a bit of an SPS advantage right now. Gosu Bomb is not having a good time of this so far, but he is trading very, very well.
Actually, yeah, that trade back too was where way fewer minions were present. So the fact that he went relatively even in damage while tanking up an entire two lines of caster minions versus just Silent Rain taking just a little bit of damage from a couple melees is indicative of the fact that Gosu T-Bomb's early chain vest is helping him a lot against what's just really double long swords.
Yeah. Gosu T-Bomb actually is leveling up his Riot Fist first.
Yep.
For that damage. It actually looks really well against Pantheon because it doesn't proc his Block Shield, where if you use the Seismic Shard, it does.
Okay.
So look at that. Like magic. And it also scales off armor.
But there's the Thunderlord's proc. I love that we just see Thunderlords on any witch champion that wants it.
Yeah.
That's so great.
I always thought that was interesting how Riot said they were just going to bounce anything else around Thunderlords instead of never
forget. Oh, man. That's good, too, yeah. Because Thunderlords is... There's really very few instances in which you would take something else.
I thought it did. I lied.
Wrong go, Mongo. Yeah.
Silent Wafaroo getting caught just a little bit, but
could be baiting a little bit. They were walking in a pretty straight line after that thrash, and the closer you get to tower, the more dangerous of a decision that becomes.
Indeed. Wafaroo having Lamps having about a 5 CS lead over Horcrux Maximus. Doing all right so far here. Right now, there is actually the gold lead has shifted back into favor of Silent Gaming away from Good Luck Jonathan. That level 1 was strong, but they didn't capitalize off it. They didn't really do anything with it.
Yeah, it was really that second gank kill on Dazillion that put that gold lead just over that 500 mark and well into the favor of Silent. Oh, the man drop's coming down. That's a good dash in as well. It's going to be Treadmaster in a lot of trouble here, but there is a great double knock-up, and Lamps is pushed back almost into tower. He does go down. Horcrux Maximus gets that, and that is going to need to be the Threshlander to get out for Rain. TP canceled on the side of Morgana. Did not want it. Morgana didn't wanna, but look at that. Silent Rain takes advantage of the situation and jumps right back in. And without even needing the TP, Moon just walks right down when Morgana's not pushing it. This is a huge fight all around. Moon is in so much trouble now, though. He's ulted himself. Gosu T-Bomb actually does make the mistake of proccing him through that ult, so he's gonna have so much more health than when he started. Tons of damage coming out from the side of Elise, but it's not gonna be enough. Carthagen. At least got a kill up top. So, really sloppy all around, but ended up actually being a 2-for-2 there just because of Parthagen's efforts in the top lane. Said, I'm going to make something of this. I know that Rain is not in a position to really do anything. I'm sorry, Dingus is not in a position to really do anything up here. Mm-hmm. So, he ran up. He just solo killed the Maokai. Incredibly smart play.
Yeah, very good play by Dingus. By Parthagen going up there. However, I think there's a bit of miscommunication going on the side of Good Luck Charm. That's the second or third time in the last couple of games we've seen Morgana or Parthagen start his teleport and then cancel it halfway through.
Very trigger happy with that spell. Oh my goodness, I can tell away. No, not a good idea.
Yeah, this is bad.
And there was nobody in lane to cancel that for him, so that was 100% canceled on his own volition.
Yep. Another time it could have been Ahri, but we weren't sure. But in this case, we do see that he canceled himself. Lamp's still having an 8 CS lead, or a 6 CS lead over the Jinx.
Despite the one death. Decent enough damage from Ghost T Bomb. He's actually been one of the more consistent laners. Surprisingly, I would say underrated. We've not probably given him the shout-outs and credit he deserves.
Definitely.
During this entire topic, but this is exemplary of his just ability to hold a lane. Very much in the style of a Dyrus, just not going to be the best, but not going to drop the ball either.
Yeah, there are times
unless
where he did hard carry.
Oh, goodness, Dingus is coming in. The Black Shield has already been down. Zilly does a great job of baiting that out just with one of those normal bombs, and that is Parthagen going down. Dingus for the return kill, mirroring that level two.
Getting that revenge kill for that solo kill in the top.
Absolutely. These two actually have been bloodying one another's noses pretty frequently, but the bleed is stronger for Good Luck Jonathan as Silent is.
Man drop is coming.
Yeah. Okay, this Treadmaster's in a lot of trouble. He actually opts to go back in. I think this is familiar. We saw this happen last time, but there is no teleport for the Malphite this time around. The Lantern comes in. So does the Ezreal ult. Not going to clear it out. Going to get him decently low. He's blinking bar at the very least.
Dingus in the least having a bit of a fight here up at the top.
Okay, here comes Moon to support though. That is Dingus coming in. Moon's on the back line. Can he ult in on this one? I think he's got the opportunity if he wants to, but Horcrux smacks his hook. There it is. Red Panda going in onto Dingus. A lot of damage across the board. Fights going off on either side. Dingus goes down. Dingus takes down Red Panda. Horcrux Maximus might die to Ezreal here, but oh, Rain gets the kill onto Treadmaster, and now goes to T-Bomb is dead. So all in all, four kills.
Morgana could be coming over here for the cleanup, though. Will
Picked
she
up.
Catch out?
This could be big. Parthagen, good player there, but this is... Still has the ultimate, slowed down by the zillion. Good flash to get away from there. Moon knew exactly what he was doing and how to do it. Red team's turret has been destroyed. And just like that, first tower of the game goes down. Right in favor of Silent. They were 1k up, now they are 3.3k up.
That did not take nearly as much as
not
we thought.
Not quite 5.5.
So close. Ooh, Morgana getting caught out with a lot of damage from zillion time ops.
Oh yeah.
Surprise. Oh my, oh my.
Oh, the downtown rocket! Jinx is gonna take that one right away.
Oh my god.
Nice ult comes out in chat. Surprisingly respectful between these two teams.
They said
they were scrimming earlier. I wonder if it just went so even that neither of them wants to start trash talking in case the other were to make some phenomenal style of play.
We do have the dragon being started over here for Good Luck Jonathan. Wafaru going to scope that out pretty well already.
Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna back right off of it. Not the biggest deal in the world. Good binding though. And he's gonna take a little bit of dragon damage on top of that. Just kind of layer it in there. Shouldn't be.
Silent Gaming able to chase him off just enough to get the advantage. Put down some more drones. Looks like they're gonna go ahead and start the dragon as well.
Wafaru taking a bit of.
This isn't anywhere nearby to try to find this away, so it looks like they were just excited to give up that dragon.
They didn't want the fight. More valuable possibly to them is that Malphite push they've got going on in the top lane.
It's going a little bit slower.
He's actually just kind of killing off waves. Almost proxy, just not behind the turret. But look, we may have something going on down in here. The assist ping's coming out as Dingus gets slammed up by the Elise Cocoon. Doesn't look like it's trying to do anything more than just distract him, hold him off for a little bit of time. Goes through T-Bombs, going to trade back this tower, equalize the turrets in the game. So now they're just down 4 kills on a dragon. That's not at all an insurmountable feat.
Not at all. I mean, right now, they're really only sitting back to settle. Our president is trying to destroy something inside of this room. Oh, Silent Moon.
Speaking of things getting destroyed, any hope Parthagin had of a kill there the second that Threshliner landed, that was destroyed.
That's true. Unfortunately, Silent Gaming is not bronze, so they do know to take the lantern. Always take the lantern. Click on it. Click on the lantern.
But never walk back for the lantern.
Yeah.
That's a golden down mistake. Don't walk back for the lantern.
Yeah. 9 times out of 10. I think a lot of respect needs to be given good Thresh players that know how to play
this. Oh, man. Look at this. Just burning the Black Shield yet again. Oh, here comes Treadmaster, though. Nice knockback. The Binding should come in, but does not. The Man Drop will be coming down. Black Shield gone again. Could have been so useful there, but is not, as Dingus is now right up in the face. And Rain and Treadmaster are going at it. There is the Thresh Lantern again. Goes through T-Bombs in a little bit of trouble. Jinx on the back line of this one, though. Could be getting off a lot. Silent Rain is solo, has no mana. Jinx wants to kill, but cannot get it. That Rocket used a little too early in the fight. Good damage by Elise. Great damage by Elise. And the follow-up coming through from Horcrux. Maximus not able to quite land what they were looking for there, as Lamps is now in the fight, ready to just hold this off. And it ends up being a 2-for-1, again, in favor of Silent. Trading out Moon, getting actually some good shutdown gold there.
Yeah. Moon actually did get the kill there as well. He got that kill on the Morgana with his time bomb that he put on her before. Yeah.
Interesting. And that kill went over to Ghost of Tsushima. Right? Not the best person to give a kill to. I mean, he'll enjoy it. He's bought the Sunfire Cake now.
Yeah. But I think it could have been more useful, like you said, on the Morgana, the Elise, or the Jinx.
Yeah, definitely. If I'm looking at this game right now, Jinx is going to be my number one win condition. Stop using Black Shield to save yourself from that bomb damage every time you have.
There's
when you need Black Shield.
May she rest in the peppermint. Here in the corner being spotted out by that.
Zillion throwing out bombs so quickly. Ghost of T-Bomb says, yeah, throw what you want at me. I'm trying to get right in your face. I got the minions. I got the Sunfire Cape. I don't know what fashion designer fucking put a cape on a rock, but they're trying anything these days. Binding doesn't quite come out.
So close. Ezreal rushing that gauntlet again. We're seeing that Iceborne gauntlet.
At least there's the tier.
Yeah, the tier is
very, very true to the days of blue build Ezreal.
The good old days. I remember when that started in Korea.
The cancer days.
Well, okay.
Everyone hated it. Everybody hated it.
No. Everybody hated the mid Ezreal with Smite.
Oh,
AP mid Ezreal with Smite.
Oh boy.
What was that? That was ridiculous.
Yeah, that was when Smite changes hit in early season 5, right?
Yep. And everybody played it mid, and it was awful.
And now here, at the start of the 2016 season, just waiting to see what the new OP WTF defining meta is.
Yeah, so far I don't think anybody's really found it. No. I think people are still trying to figure out the Keystone Masteries and how to get them to work how they want.
Yeah, exactly. We'll see a little bit there. Jinx, 2-1-0, has the IE. Probably stronger than the Ezreal in this instance. I think, honestly, if they just went toe-to-toe, slamming and jamming, I would give that one over to Jinx.
Oh, yeah.
So I really have to call into question just leaving her bot lane to farm. This is one of those champions that you actually need to get out there and make your own advantages with.
Yeah, you need to have her participating in those fights, especially when you have a comp that's really built around.
Oh, boy. Speaking of fight participation, looks like we may have 5 members trying to participate all up in Malphite's lane. Maybe not then.
Nah,
just a scuttle
like
grab. Going in for the Rift Herald, perhaps. Rain and Gosu T-Bomb seeing one another. Treadmaster, you keep walking onto those. Silent Rain is looking for the man drop back in the back lines behind them as they're coming in. Treadmaster in a lot of damage. Pantheon, though, onto Parthagin. Good Morgana ult, but oh, the flash in. Generally, people flash out of that, but Silent Rain knew he could take care of it. The Thresh is not going to be there to save Lamps, but Lamps may be able to save himself with the help of his team. That was huge coming in onto Panderp, getting that lockup, keeping Lamps alive just long enough. 4 deaths on the side of Good Luck Jonathan for absolutely nothing. A 4-0 favor Silent Gaming, 14-5.
That was extremely good. Two time bombs in a row by Zillion, keeping Lamps alive.
Oh yeah.
He came out of that, out of the Zillion ult, and he was kept alive very, very well. I was impressed because I thought he was going to die in that fight. He only had about 200 health left, and with that double stun, anybody who was going to kill Ezreal.
Oh yeah. And Ezreal is the one with that Rift Herald pushing now, especially annoying, proccing that Iceborne every 2 seconds. Going to be able to slam out this tower. Great play from Silent Gaming.
Yeah.
Silent Moon running away with the Zillion Time Warp. Oh boy.
We're definitely seeing the power of the Zillion right now coming out with the double time bombs, putting those stuns out on the Morgana, putting those stuns out on the other teams. Getting the bombs out on Alistar to be annoying. You know? Silent Lamps having the empowered minions in the mid lane does give them.
Yeah, basically, all he has to do is just sit here and keep throwing out his Qs. That damage should overwhelm most of Good Luck, Jonathan. Moon just teleporting back to lane, burns that one out. Not too big of a deal. Dragon is in the same area, but may not be what they have their eyes set on. Ghostly T-Bomb does have teleport, so if this does turn into a dragon fight, we may see that wombo combo over on the side of Good Luck Jonathan that they were possibly looking to pull out. Maybe they want to rush down this mid tower instead. Looks like that does seem to be the more likely objective. Trading a dragon for a tower. This is only second dragon, so mid lane tower, if they can get it, which it does not look like they can, would have been a better objective pick. Barthogen, if you use Black Shield here, yes, okay, actually give them to stop.
Oh,
Ghost T-Bomb may have to just ult right back into this to keep himself alive for a little while. Ult away, perhaps not ulting at all. No, there it is, the Wombo bump up, but Alistar was not in there. There is the double knockup, but they did not have it at the same time that they wanted to. Silent Wombaroo in a lot of trouble, but he seems to be the only one as Rain is jumping right in onto Treadmaster's face, and that is one dead support. Cow is gone. Triple kill actually going out for the Maokai jungle. Zillion should have this one locked up. Walking away, very confident on that. Knew there was no summoner heal to really save the day in that instance. And again, 4-0 on a team fight of Silence choosing.
Yeah, we are seeing Silence like pull away very, very easily. These fights are becoming much more winnable, much more on the side of Silence. Silent Rain doing very, very well in that Pantheon. I would not be surprised if you see that ban maybe come in.
Get Pantheon the Bantheon.
We don't want one. So,
what is it? Water?
No. Okay, sorry. We had a minor discussion about water. Speaking of water, everybody's stacking up their wards in the river, trying to get some extra vision down there.
Dragon, of course, off the table from that last little skedaddle where pretty much Silent just took Dragon and then walked up to force a fight and won that 4-0. So really the next big objective before any Dragon is going to be the Baron. That's really the only one like rotatable on the map besides the towers, and I really don't think Silent has the tower control right now to start taking that Baron. They could just kind of group up, bait it, and force another fight. That's always a viable option. But if they really want to make sure they've got the wave pressure to pull this off as properly as possible, it's going to take pushing in at least that first top tier turret, which Pantheon looks like is at least attempting.
Yeah, they don't have the ward presence yet either, like you said, because they don't have that tower pressure. It's going to be a bit of a long setup for them because they have been putting out their pink wards and putting out their pink wards.
Oh yeah, they've got the vision down to AT. Man drop coming down. Treadmaster's in a lot of trouble here. He is so beat up and bruised. Barthogen may die 1v1 to Lamps. Yes, Lamps solo killing the mid laner. That's a pretty big misstep. Barthogen is actually the only one to die. Treadmaster does live. I think they knocked off the chase the second Ezreal's like, hang on, I already got someone. The pick's done though here.
Uh-oh.
Speaking of picks, Silent Moon in a lot of trouble. Can get Headbutt back into the tower, and yes, he's going to have to ult himself. Jinx is going to be looking to get that zap right in off the return, but holy cow, the damage from Moon. Great shutdown, but look at that, only barely surviving that. That was so much burned on just one member. That is how strong Moon is. 4 deaths on Zillion, but every single time he dies, he takes a little bit more of Good Luck Jonathan away with him. They've been pushing in this top tower. They're gonna get the second one. I don't think Morgana has the wave clear unless they just want to back right off, which they do. They say goodbye.
Yeah, you don't want any of that.
I think I could have jumped her.
Oh, yeah, probably. Oh, Wafaru getting out just in time before the officer spots him out.
Hey, Morgana. Getting the consolation prize minion. The thanks for playing. Oh, if this resets, it's not gonna. Ezreal's just gonna take it right away. And Treadmaster, too little too late on two fronts.
Yeah, that seems to be an ongoing theme right now for good luck, Jonathan. Too little too late.
Treadmaster's played pretty well on this Alistar, but I feel like just without the Poppy, he's not living up to his true potential as a support.
He's really not. His Poppy support was pretty good.
I know. I feel like that could actually at least spruce things up a little bit in here.
Yeah. If we were to look back and say, where did this team go wrong? I'm still looking back at that level one advantage that they had, and they didn't really capitalize.
Nothing. They, in fact, just let Maokai get the early gank off to Morgana. Great play by Silent, actually. They knew that Morgana had used her flash in that initial fight. Yep. A lot of summoners went down, and for Silent to be able to... Oh, no, Treadmaster. For Silent to be able to keep track of that is actually rather impressive because... there were so many defensive and aggressive flashes from everybody.
Yeah.
That to know Morgana really didn't stand a chance of getting out there was a well-coordinated play, stretching out to about 8K gold now, just from the little advantages that they've been able to squeeze out here.
Yeah.
It's been big fights based on small mistakes.
Yeah. They're setting up this Baron very well. They've got the Vision Agent. They've got the Zillion out there playing defensive against that house.
There's the teleport coming in from the mount, but he's just going to want to ult right to the pit while they're all grouped up. And pretty actually, no, I'm sorry, that was the Morgana, what I meant to say. Silent Dingus only now just popping the Banshee Veil. The man drop in as he flashes, following Parthenon, who flashes out as well, making it a little bit of a drag. But Silent Lance gets that one with the kill. Silent Rain on the back line is in trouble. The Panderp is going to go down, and they are just tearing apart the back line before they even bother with the front line. Rampage now as Horcrux Maximus is down, and that should be the ace as Ghost of T-Bomb is the next one to fall. Ezreal picking himself up a nice couple kills in that fight. Getting overshadowed by his support action.
Yeah, there's clean ace by Silent Man there.
A little bit of the BM.
All of their most played champions.
That's pretty rude. Silent Gaming. A few sportsmen.
Putting out flashing swag. Zillion teleporting to the top lane.
Yeah, they can pretty much just take this tower uncontested. If they were to rotate, which they're not, so. Zillion just wants to clear the wave, keep the pressure up, I suppose. I don't think he's gonna get the tower here. Morgana should be able to scare him right off, but look at that damage. Parthenon, what is your answer? Oh no. And Parthenon. Been quite honestly disappointing as a player this series. We've expected, not series, but this game, we've expected a lot out of him. Oh, it was really exciting. Parthenon versus Moon, you know, one of the better mid laners we've seen this entire time is now 1-7-3.
Yeah.
Just absolutely
I think
destroyed.
I think he's tilting himself a little bit, to be honest. He played really well against Mordekai, who is a good mid laner.
Oh, Mordekai, yeah, the mid laner who reached Master last season.
He played very strongly, and his Morgana was really strong, and this time it's just very underwhelming against the Zillion.
Well, it's the black shields that are just...
He's
they're
using
just
too soon.
Bad.
They're too
they're
soon.
Bad black shields, Parthenon. I'm sorry, but you throw it on yourself to negate the damage from a bomb, and then all of a sudden they're like, oh, let's throw all these stuns at him because you didn't want to take a little bit of chip and poke damage. I understand it, but just buy a pot and start drinking that pot the second look. The thing
no, it's
hits
true.
On you as well.
Especially because the biscuits are very strong. They last 10%. Last 10%. I've always been a big fan of Frost. They're very cost efficient for what they do.
To his credit, he's kept up very well in CS.
That's true. He is.
I'm not trying to. I'm not trying to just like destroy everything you love here, Parthenon.
But at the same time,
you were supposed to be the chosen one. All supposed right, to destroy the feed, not the comet.
Oh, you win the greater. We've done it, boys.
Okay, Silent Dingus can take out a lot of this tower just by running around. Leaves and lets the minion finish the dirty work. He's still got the Banshee's Veil, so he's actually just not worried about any CC coming out from the side of good luck, Jonathan. Spamming the laugh. That's dirty. Silent. Tisk, tisk. What would your mother think?
I will say he's not, at least they're not spamming it in front of the enemy team. It's only on stream.
Yeah, probably, yeah.
The bomb delivery system with the minions, very clever. I personally love that play.
Oh yeah, the tossing a minion in, just too perfect. Those clips that always hit the front page of Reddit where, you know, someone does it in solo queue to secure a level one kill.
Yes.
Oh, gotta love it. Yeah, a lot of backline bombs coming out from Dingus as well. Thematic play here from Silent.
Oh, not the aggro.
Lamp's maybe caught, but that is just the cleanse right off of it. Not gonna bother with that. Uses FQSS, says no thank you. I'm gonna turn around a good bit of damage just from that Iceborne. That's off cooldown every second. Goes through T-Bomb. They actually die. They're diving the tankiest member, but it does not matter. Godlike for Silent Dingus. Silent Rain is in a lot of trouble here, but the ult is going to keep him alive. Dingus does go down, though. That is a shutdown coming out for Vayne. Treadmaster is looking to be the next one to fall. Moon jumping way back into the tower and possibly too far. The shielding is coming out for him from that really fresh drop of that shield there. Oh, Parthage in the downtown shot. That's what I'm talking about, buddy. That's what we wanted to see.
I think he heard us.
And it doesn't matter. A little too hard. What is
Parthage.
Oh boy. Okay.
Maybe he didn't hear us.
Maybe
he didn't hear us.
Okay. A little bit of a silly play from Parthage, but I think he understands that this game is pretty well lost.
Yeah, this is pretty done.
I don't think we're gonna be seeing that same 10k gold comeback that we maybe saw from Silent earlier in the day.
Oh, there's a part of me that hopes we do not.
Oh, goodness.
Please. That 42-minute comeback was exhausting. Just to watch.
Yeah. Just Silent, though, playing through it perfectly.
They did.
That really just gave them the momentum they need.
Yeah, I think after coming back from that, they're telling themselves nothing could be as bad as what we just did there.
No, I understand it. Yeah.
Oh, man. Honestly, looking at the side of Good Luck Johnson, their team comp is good, but they're not playing it very well. That Jinx is always getting dove. She's not playing it very safe in that match.
That's frustrating too, because I would argue that actually Jinx is the best player on this team right now. Horcrux Maximus, though, has not been someone we've really touched on a lot over the streams that we've had of Good Luck Johnson,
is currently in this game outshadowing all of his teammates.
Yeah.
It's really been the Parthagen and Red Panderp show up until now.
Oof. Yeah.
But I guess it's just, you know, Horcrux Maximus's warm-up act.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll see the Red Panderp and Parthagen we know and love coming out next game.
Yeah, Red Panderp, like I said, after having that Kindred banned away, he is not performing very well in that Elise. I wonder if they're going to try to force him into the Elise again.
But you know what? In the first day, he was a monster on Rek'Sai.
Yeah.
And he went 4-0-14 on Rek'Sai in just like one of the most dominant performances we've seen over the past couple days.
Yeah.
And it's just, we've not seen him pick it up since. It's been Elise or Kindred. And obviously, Silent has done an incredible job of playing around this Elise. They've got some great picks that can really just
Come
down. Oh, Rain's in a lot of trouble. Panther maybe the one turning the trouble in onto him as he goes down to Dingus. That is eighth death. Rain, though, gonna get caught up. That is the shutdown onto Pantheon. He did not have the time for the Zillion ult. Zillion ult is still around somewhere. Moon doing a lot of damage. Rampage coming out for Silent Lamp. The hook hits onto Horcrux Maximus, and he's gonna obviously go down to this one fresh. Getting the shutdown gold, and Treadmaster is going to go down for the double kill of Ezreal. This looks to be the ace, not quite clean, as the death of Pantheon did occur. Parthage missing another shot. Going to take him down. There's the GGs coming out. The inhibitor is taken out as they're just maybe going to clear this next inhibitor to double up their wave pressure for these towers. They certainly have all the time in the world that they need. 10 seconds, but it's only on Elise. I think they've got this one torn right apart here. Good game to Silent Gaming as they go up 1-0 in the series. Oh, Waffle Room. So close. Oh, the Zillion ult. So tall.
Yeah, Ezreal only having one death this game. Lamp playing impeccable. Waffle Room playing extremely well with a 6-0-16 score.
6-0-16 thresh. You'd think he was a top lane with that score.
Very, very strong game coming out from Silent Gaming right at the beginning there.
Oh, man. Well, there you go. That is game one.
The team said they're kind of hungry.
Yeah, if we could do like 15 minutes here.
15 minutes is fine.
Dude, sub me in, coach.
Yeah, Brian Starkey still needs to.
I still gotta eat my food.
Catch up on the slacking that he's been doing.
I know. I gotta send off that work email too. It's my fault for the delay. I apologize. Unfortunately, I am a semi-adult. A semi-adult. I wouldn't say full adult because adulting is hard. It's scary.
There are no grown-ups in eSprats. Only big kids.
Yeah, I know. I already said I was a liar. No one ever trusts me anyway, dude. It's my life. Let me check and see.
All right, so we're going to take a quick break. We'll be back in about 15 minutes.
Let me check and see if these guys are.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Kyle Corvus Crow here, back with Brian Ninjas and Scout Starkey to call some teams bad, to put down the bias, to hate on everyone that even comes around. Loki doesn't matter anymore. We don't need him. Just run it, Dingus.
Let's go.
Come on.
Bruh.
Okay, stop complimenting each other. Start the game. The biggest compliment you can pay him is landing more of those thresh hooks.
I was going to say this makes me feel awkward. Can we just go outside?
I was hoping you'd sent that because then I was going to type moist asterisk.
Oh, God. I hate that word. Did you say that on stream? Our duo is done. We are done. Don't you say moist to me again.
Oh, gosh.
Vane coming out as a quick
man. The ultimatums. That word never gave me any ultimatums. Just saying.
Who?
Said that word.
That word.
That suddenly you're so uncomfortable with.
Ah!
Just like your mother.
Ah, oh, damn. Actually, I am uncomfortable with my mother. She makes me feel very well.
Van and Chen, mirror bands coming out again. Didn't want to deal with any of that. Kindred, Mundo on the other side of Silent. They are on the red side for this game. Zillion, Gonorino. Whoops.
What?
That sounded uncomfortably close to something. That's all right.
The Zillion is Gonoru, as they say.
First pick of the Ezreal. That's actually the second time we've seen Ezreal first pick taken away from whichever game of the team.
Ripping Lamps.
He was previously a part of. You're not in the pick and ban phase, so you're actually going to have to wait. That's okay, because you can see it over our shoulders right here.
So
taking the time for Silent. Not really in any rush to pick these next two.
I wonder if they're going to go Kalista Alistar. Alistar was open. He got left. He made it through.
Yeah, quite possible. Jax was a pick. Not necessarily banned a lot, but Rand maybe wanted to get back in onto that one. Actually, it may have been Dingus playing the jungle Jax. Jax of the jungle. That could come out pretty huge here.
Yeah. Be fun to watch.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Excuse me, gotta get a cough drop. The shoutcasting is getting me a little scratchy. Oh my.
Choking down the cough drops.
Thank you, Halls.
Yeah, they really need to start sponsoring professional esports.
Maybe we should ask Halls if they can sponsor.
Halls and the guys that make hand warmers that you see in every esports, like flicking it back and forth, like, okay, yeah, gotta get the hand warm while we're all making jokes because we're kind of nervous about playing. I feel like maybe Riot does that with the LCS. They're like, hey guys, pretend you just said something really funny so we have something great for after the game.
So they're just sitting there like laughing, and you're like, I don't even know what they're laughing about right now, but.
You know a perk of Howard's now that he has working at Riot?
Well,
apparently, if he wants to, on weekends, he can ref the LCS games.
I saw that,
which
yeah.
means, he can ref the LCS games, which means his headset is wired in to the team comms, and he can listen to professional team comms while he just stands behind them, making sure they're not cheating. Any of us could do that. He's not paid for that work.
I feel like I could do it, mostly because when I stand, I look really good when I stand up.
Oh, I know.
Good job, Riot. Way to hire pretty refs.
You know what? We need to start that as a viral meme. We need to make sure that, like, every single time Howard is shown on screen refing, like, for whatever, like, everyone is just, like, hot grill. Just, like, just for him particularly, like, to the point where maybe he gets, like, his own Twitch emote, like, of his face.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes.
The five of us must make this happen. Okay, so picks and bans, because we're really devoted to this. Because we care. Lulu coming out for Dingus, taking that one away from, Well, it's not Dingus, actually. He's just the one picking it, hovering it. We'll see these swaps around. Silent's giving us a runaround. We really can't predict what they're going to do because they always swap it.
Yeah, Pandurb actually did just straight up pick up that Vi.
Yeah, no, took it right away from the hands of Dingus. Probably that means he's just going to relegate himself to the Jax and pick, like, another weird top laner for Rain.
I don't know. Rain very well could just take that Lulu top because they already have the thresh in the bottom lane.
That would be Moon then coming in. He's tried to counterpick every single time he's got a chance with lane. So I wouldn't be surprised if he said, okay, yeah, I'm going to be going up against what looks like either the Ezreal or the Corki.
Mm-hmm.
I know I can play Galio safe into both of those. Go ahead, pick the Galio. No, Rammus the Slammus, could this be? Do not tease me. Don't taunt me. Just say it's okay.
I saw what you did there, and that was clever.
Thank you. I want it. I want it so bad. Give me the Rammus. Just do it. Just do it. Just do it! Don't let your memes just be memes, Silent Moon.
I feel like the majority of our cast is just like Danger Zone and, mm-hmm.
Oh.
And memes. No, the Galio again. The Mitch. It's like hard to say anything new about some of these comps.
No, I know. Like we've seen the same thing coming out. The Callista for Lamps is definitely different.
Soraka
mid. Been hovering it all time. Yep. Just kind of like, okay, we're in the finals now. We really don't have anything to hold back. Let's show the pick.
Soraka mid. There's no way Soraka's mid.
Who else is mid? That Thresh is support. That Lulu is top.
What do you mean? Rain could take Jax top.
Swerve.
Oh. What? Wow. No, please. Oh, God.
Hey, you remember that time I told you so?
Shut up, Kyle.
Soon. Soraka mid, Silent Moon. He's played every other champion that's immobile in AP, so why not Soraka as well?
I mean, it's not like he can heal himself.
The mid laner for Good Luck Jonathan is Parthogen, who's running Ezreal into a Soraka. We get a little bit of splash of bot lane in the mid. Ladies and gentlemen, we have...
Gosu bomb, taking Cho'Gath top. Keeping up. Parthogen is keeping Ezreal in the mid lane.
Yep. That's going to be the Ezreal, not the Corki. Probably what we expected. Very solid draft from blue side again. Blue side's got, you know, a proclivity for drafting. They've got a certain... Yeah. Talent, what's that?
It's an actual team.
No, man, Silent has a real team. I could easily justify this right here.
He's got three supports on that team. It's fine.
Dude, what do you mean? Three supports? Okay, listen. I'm going to explain to you here. Uses. And Karma.
Karma, Morgana.
And Morgana.
We got. Who was the other one? Soraka makes five now. We saw Karma, Morgana.
Galio.
Galio.
Morgana's okay. So is Karma.
Karma is.
We saw somebody weird the other day.
She's not cheese. She's not cheese. She's just bad.
She's just good.
Until she gets camped.
Whoa.
And then 1v2 is your team because she does too much damage.
You can go ahead and start the spec.
So, I would have to say the every time we've said we like the opposing team's comp more than Silent Gaming, Silent Gaming has won.
True. Again, here's my test of this. If you gave two SK Telecoms, if you cloned them and have... Faker v. Faker.
Yes.
Blue SK Telecom would beat purple SK Telecom.
He has said this multiple times, and every time he says that, though, it's like purple SK Telecom wins.
No, I know, because Silent Gaming is just probably the better players in this instance.
Oh, my God, the flat out.
Yep.
They're better.
They have more experience together.
They all have silent power.
Can I get some 1Gs in the chat?
Good job, Scott.
I am to the point of calling it like I see it. It's the color caster's job to dance around like facts aren't necessarily facts and everything's too complicated. Play-by-play casters. Died more? You. Winner perp squad.
That's true. I don't know how to math. Kyle knows how to math. As we've seen multiple times.
He's the one with the college education.
I know, it's true. There's been like four times this stream where I've tried to calculate the cold difference. Gold difference? The gold difference.
Gold difference?
Dude, it's these cough drops, man. They're very cold. Halls. The cold difference. Yeah, I've tried to calculate gold difference and I can't do it. Like, I think one of them was like. It was not. It was not good. No, he can't yet. You can't do it.
No, you usually can't. Because if in the first 3 minutes of the game, doesn't it just always show this countdown 3 minute screen? Yeah. Hey.
First, before you do that, you gotta
do getting down to the wire. Game number two of potentially five.
Please.
Potentially.
Please, Kyle. It's probably because the game's loading in now. Yep.
Oh, yeah. Well, actually, one of the better things about these two teams here in the finals is we do get quite a slew of fights between them. Red Panderp and Parthigin just love to slap people around. Horcrux Maximus, a lot more defensive of an AD carry.
Yeah.
But still knows when and where to find the damage. And it's working out pretty well. Hey, look at this. Only two icon masteries for Silent to toot their own horns with.
Oh, indeed. Well, no, there's four.
But you can't drop the icon if you don't have level 5.
No, you can with 4, can't you?
You can?
Yeah, you can do it with 4.
Can you drop the icon?
You can do it with 4, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
My goodness.
Yeah, so
well, it's unofficial, so if anybody but the bot lane does it.
You can drop it.
You can flex your stuff.
Well.
All right, looks like we got Lulu going in the top lane.
Lulu in the top lane.
Oh, no, stop.
To bring some of that
Lulu
top pain.
Oh.
And maximize the top gains.
Listen, you knew what you signed up for when you started sitting behind us, Trent.
No. The camera is not on.
Parthigin is, Good Luck Jonathan are just kind of chilling in this bush. They maybe trying to get another little.
Yeah, it worked out for them last time.
It did.
The
no.
The ward's coming down. Soraka. Soraka's going to ward this. They know.
Nope.
Moon is aware.
Nope. Right there.
Look at it! Oh, the flash comes out! Moon is gonna get away, but the pulverize does come up. They're gonna try to get it. The exhaust comes down. That's 2 summoner spells already. Red Panda may be able to get onto this one. Horcrux Maximus looking for it. The flash, the knock into the Corki first. Blood twice now.
It worked the first time. Soraka like walked up. She doesn't have a warding trinket. She took the clearing trinket to try to clear out that red bush right away. And she saw them.
Next level strats. This is some season 2 CLG. They've got the strats for blue side. We're gonna see them pull out the win.
I don't know. I think for me it really depends. Is Panderp going to try to camp that mid lane after they already got the flash out of the Soraka?
You know, here's what's worrying about Panderp for me. This time around, is we saw her on Elise, different jungler from Vi, but not entirely a huge departure in the playstyle that you run with that.
Wait, why is Thresh at the red zone? What?
Yeah. Silent, maybe with a little bit of disrespect, just trying to keep jungle paths down.
Oh,
Jax did start on that red buff side, so maybe he's trying to make sure he can safely run right across to the blue when he's done with this. That would be a huge indication if I'm Goku Bomb. Run down to blue after maybe level 2 or 3, push the wave in, which is not a hard thing to do against an early Lulu as Cho'Gath. Push that wave, run down, ward your blue. That's how you keep it safe. Silent Moon. It slapped around a bit.
What do you think Silent Moon is going to level first? Because his Q will do more damage, but it'll heal for more if he levels his W.
Which skill is which?
W is his heal. Q is his star call.
Ah. Probably star call, to be honest. Moon is so aggressive.
For the damages.
Yep.
Huh? Yeah, but I'm saying, but if you level your W, your star call heals you more.
Yeah, that is true. I think it's going to be more trading just sheer damage than trading health back.
Yeah.
There's that push we were talking about. And look, there's Jax on that red side or blue side of the jungle. Maybe coming actually up into T-Bomb in a minute here. We'll see. He's just killing the crap.
Yep.
And down it goes. And possibly Cho to follow suit here as he is running into that top lane of things. Cho pushed very far up. Inga should be in good position to just make something happen here. So much damage coming out off the bat. And he's done so. Goodbye, Cho'Gath. Silent Dingus has this talent, this nose for just sniffing out, this guy's pushed up, I can kill him, no problem. It's happened every single game we've seen them play. Sometimes, the first time somebody pushes mid, guess who's there? Silent Dingus.
That's true. Panderp still hasn't made that rotation mid. Still hasn't made that rotation mid. He's just now getting there.
Mm-hmm.
But Soraka, she's playing it safe, man.
Mm-hmm.
Playing it safe.
If I would have to play against Silent Gaming tomorrow, my strategy would be invade some jungle,
take a buff, and then, like, at level 3, pick a jungler that can just gank the ever-living buffoon out of top.
Yep.
Because that's actually how Silent Gaming almost lost their game against, yeah, Lucky in the Wards, is top lane just got absolutely stopped dead in its tracks.
Yeah.
Whereas now top lane's already got an assist and a kill on the lane opponent. Maybe starting a little bit of that Tiltorino.
Yeah. Gotta get their shot card on tilt. Yeah, top laners are shot calling.
Because it's Silent Rain.
Uh-huh. That is Silent Rain in the top lane.
Ding is getting the
cool. Gonna drop that one right on out. Not gonna put it on any champion's faces. That actually, yeah, that's first blue. Because he started red side and then just ran straight to the top. So, 5 minutes for the first blue means we're not gonna see anything on that Soraka until around 10.
Yeah. Soraka's probably gonna go back and get fairy charms. Oh, Frostfang. Yep, that's a good one. Mm-hmm. Get some mana regen from that. She's gonna go the spooky ghost.
Information so obvious to us, it's so difficult to infer from the other side of things.
Oh, yeah.
But that's what really separates the great teams from really just these solo queue mentality teams of, like, knowing when that next move is going to come up and how to take advantage of that.
Yeah.
The call may seem so clear to us in the hindsight of things,
yeah,
exactly how Good Luck Jonathan may play this.
Red Panda looks like she's coming in for a mid, a bottom lane
possible
gank.
Kalissa Thresh is a darn hard lane to gank. Oh, but Thresh was not paying attention. There is the flash, the back end of the Helgort. Yeah, it is. Silent Wobbler is going to go so low. The summoner heal does come out, but I don't think it's going to be enough. As Corki jumps on in, Horcrux Maximus is going to get that kill for himself. Red Panda, though, may go very low. The summoner heal again, delaying that, keeping it. Hey, okay. Oh, Shogath in the top lane, getting a solo kill onto Rain. The turnaround. Oh, boy. Now here we go. Parthogen just burned the E to go in. Jax knows that the time is right. The patience is so big. They were waiting for that, and the flash does come out.
Later! Everybody loves themselves some Trick.
You guys remember that one time that Trick 2G was the jungler for CLG?
Bro, was it season 1?
Trick
2G
was never the jungler for CLG. Yes, he was. He played with them at 9 a.m.
No. That was Trick.
What?
Other Trick.
That was not the European Trick. I know, there's Gamers 2 Trick, and then there's actually Trick 2G. We're consulting the Google right now. Brian's going to have to do the solo cast for a second.
I will do solo cast. All right, so we've got Thresh from Silent Gaming. Wafuru is looking around there, trying to get some wards out, see if he can do a little something in the mid lane. But he does get spotted out by all of the really good wards of... the really good wards of Good Luck Jonathan. Man, I cannot remember their name. But right now, there's not a whole lot of action happening. Lulu did get solo killed by Cho'Gath in the top lane and is down by 2 CS right now. Treadmaster clearing out a pink ward that's up there in the river. Kalista having a 7 CS lead over the Corki, but Corki has 2 kills on her right now. Excuse me. Ezreal using his Arcane Barrage to try and clear that wave. Silent Rain can be knocked by Ghost of Tidon. Special Delivery is available for Corki, so he can go back and get that if he so chooses. Right now there's not a whole lot of happening, but I would like to come in, give a shout out to Good Luck Jonathan for their really good pink wards that they have guarding that bottom lane. They know that Dingus really likes coming down that way, and they have a lot of wards to be able to spot him out and see if that is going to be a problem for them in the future. Red Panda coming in. Oh, Silent Moon gets knocked up, and there's Steel coming out. Will he live? Oh, he's gonna lock up. Silent Moon does the trade on the Vi.
Absolutely terrible.
Dingus getting the return kill as well. So we've got a 2-for-1 situation in the mid lane. Red Panda went too far underneath the turret, got caught up by Soraka's wishing.
That's her.
Huh? Equinox. Yeah, okay, got caught by Soraka's
okay,
Equinox.
Okay, that's the name I was going to say.
The silence
Ultimate,
and
that
the...
Oh, no. Yeah, that would be bad.
Star Cold.
Is it Astral Blessing or Astral Infusion?
Infusion was cool.
Was Infusion not a spell from...
Oh, what's that? Having a flash away. We've got two kills on Dingus and only three assists coming out of Panderp. Panderp mm-hmm. did have a little bit of misplay there in the mid lane. That will set them a little bit behind in terms of what they could have gotten out of that gank. A bit over aggressive, I think, going under that turret. A little too early from Panderp.
The differences in the CS is astounding, too. Just the efficiency with which Jax has been ganking. Arguably, his ganks are harder to pull off than Dai's. Especially since they're so flash reliant in terms of making that stun happen on the last minute turnarounds. So big difference in just that he's been able to out farm and out gank this guy here.
Yeah.
Definitely gonna be one of the exciting factors in how this game tips from here as we are getting just about even on this gold. Still a little bit in the favor of Good Luck Jonathan, as they do have that extra kill kind of keeping them up where they may be lacking in CS, particularly to the jungle, and maybe a little bit in the AD realm. Made up for, though, in that mid lane. Mid Soraka, not looking as confident as we maybe thought.
The Soraka in mid was always very, very skeptical to me.
Yeah.
I feel like towards the middle in the late game, when you start team fighting more, that Soraka's going to be damn annoying.
Yeah. I mean, at this point, basically it's protect the Kalista.
Yeah.
With a little bit of spicy Jax sauce on top.
Good
spicy
reset,
Jax getting a little bit spicier as he takes on that dragon solo. Gonna get that damage increase. Turn the gold lead, about 100. Second time, Alistair jumping right on in. Waffle's taking the brunt of the damage, but it is gonna be the toss in from Lance. We're gonna check on Moon, actually, as he's getting ganked. The Ezreal ult does not hit on a stationary target, but he does come in to get the kill. Regardless, that is the assist for Vi. That's exactly what she needed. And we are looking back in business here for Good Luck Jonathan, stretching that gold lead once again back into their favor.
I mean, it's true, she was just standing there. Wrong. Silent Rain coming in towards the mid lane, but getting poked out by Parthenogen.
I think actually Parthenogen should be able to deal a lot of damage out of Rain if Rain were to stick around. Mana is not there necessarily for Parthenogen, but Rain has shown himself arguably one of the weaker to weakest mechanical players of the Silent Squad, which is not that big of a knock because honestly this is an entirely mechanically gifted squad. That's like how Wild Turtle's the worst player on Immortals. That's just an objective fact. He's not bad. He's just
the worst player on the team.
And not even like the worst player, but like mechanically. So especially on a champion like Lulu, yeah, there's tons of outplay potential for Parthenogen there if he'd stuck around.
Yeah, definitely.
That's where I was going with that one.
I appreciate you trying. Jax walking around with that Devour, trying to get that stacked. He already has 19 going on it. Only needs to get to 30. 11 more to go. He's farming very efficiently, mostly on champions, really.
Yeah, no kidding.
Waffleroo looking, trying to bully out that Corki, trying to get a little bit of aggression, maybe free up some time for his AD carry Kalista to get in there and get some free farm.
Rick Herald.
Rick Herald.
That's certainly going to help with that. Giving it over to Rain. Gonna allow him just some serious pushing pressure against this Cho'Gath.
Yeah, allow him to apply a little bit more pressure.
Definitely good. He's down that one kill to Cho'Gath.
Man, the Dirk's camera does not know what it wants to do.
Wow. Action's gaining traction.
Okay. Silent Rain doing
the
fancy feet.
That wasn't stationary. That
fancy feet.
He was moving and Cho'Gath is...
Oh, Treadmaster doing the flash pulverizing.
Hey, look at that. Boom. Knock it up. Slam it down. The Vorpal Spikes. There's a double knock up return in from the Lulu part. But now that's on the screen. And goes to Bomb. Having to flash. Good flash away from the stun, but Jax is ready to flash in right on that Empowered Strike. Gosu Bomb
running for it, drops it right below them so they can't keep going. Smart call when your biggest threat is melee.
Yeah, there was a bit of a right wasted by Jackson in the top lane. He also didn't use his Chilling Smite either.
Probably didn't think he needed it. Maybe just wasn't hashtag worth. They just want to maybe force out the Cho'Gath, peel off that tower, take it out of the map. They look to be turning back. Red Panda could be so dead here if he does not flash. He does flash. There is the Alistar going in. A little bit of miscommunication. You want to do that while Red Panda is still tanking the tower. What a turnaround, though. Lamps is just making a fool out of this dive, and Treadmaster's going to go down. That's the double kill. Ruffleroo with some huge peel, but here is Parthogen, maybe going to get this kill onto Thresh. Looks like he may be able to do it. Callista might. Yeah, she's not going to be able to help heal that up. Horcrux Maximus now in trouble to Moon, dying to the mid.
Soraka. The bananas.
But look at that big choke. He's angry. Good silence onto the Jack.
But it's too late.
Too late. Parthogen is dead. Could this be across the map clear? No, because Silent Dingus cannot kill the big angry Cho'Gath.
Yeah.
Oh, there's the knockup. I don't know if Gosubon wants this. Yes, he does, as Red Panda is in here. Silent Dingus getting absolutely devoured. Om nom 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 nom. Oh, look at that. Look at that pickup from Jax. Right on the board. Just didn't even bother. He got himself.
Getting through Rage Blade. Yeah. Sated Devour.
They know he bought that Rage Blade straight up. There was nothing else in his inventory besides that Sated Devour and boots. And he just bought the Rage Blade.
So much gold.
Oh boy. Lamp's getting knocked back. 7-7 on the board. 3k gold advantage.
Oh, pressure room coming
silent.
In.
Yeah, misses up the play. Doesn't quite get what he was looking for there, but Corki was well aware on time just to butt out of that one. Alistar feeling. Good awareness, presence of mind to get out before the Vi could come down, cause any havoc. They didn't have the tower necessarily at their backs to help them repeat that.
Phenomenal 2v1.
Phenomenal 3v1, or 3v2.
That's right.
3v2. We know how to map here.
Yes.
Numbers don't mean anything, action means everything.
That's right.
As no esports, go fighting.
Go. The 2.8 goal lead for Silent Gaming is kind of speaking for itself right now. They're taking the small advantages and making them even larger.
Sure, they turn just some general pressure with that Rift Herald into a top lane tower, as well as just destroying this game from the bottom lane. Parthogen gets a kill on the Moon, though. There's Dingus turning it back around onto Treadmaster, but I would definitely take a solo kill in mid for a jungle kill onto the support. The assists, though, are going to make that a little bit sweeter on the side of Silent Gaming.
Yeah, that Soraka pick was a little bit conceited, I think, in that mid lane.
Perhaps. 2-4-1 is the worst score we've seen Moon have this entire tournament.
It just doesn't seem to be working that well quite yet. It could get better, for all I know, it could get better, but as of right now, it is not helping Moon.
Possibly, this may just be setting up for the Ballista, already 3-0-1, has that Blade of the Ruined King Dragon given over to her as well, with that second dragon pushing power, right as she conveniently is stopping.
Yeah.
But it's been the bot side on Silent that's really been setting the tone for this game. Actually, on the top side of the map, if you take a look at things, things are going pretty well for Good Luck Jonathan. They got the solo kill in the top lane, Cho'Gath on the Lulu. He's got another kill squeezed out somewhere on there. I believe he killed Soraka or Thresh.
He devoured the Jax.
The Jax, that is. That, he devoured the Devourer. That is correct.
Shaboom.
And then Ezreal as well. 421, unfortunately, 4-2-1.
So close.
Just one assist over.
He almost had the potential to be on the dank team.
Well, yeah, unfortunately, he's not part of the dank team. I can't tank just hard enough, but has dunked hard enough onto the Soraka. Jax doing a good bit of damage to Gosubon. Gosubon, maybe not paying so much attention. Didn't really quite realize he was there. The silence might keep him alive, might not. We'll have to see on this one. Does he have the summoner spells to get out? It looks like no, if he can just rupture behind him. That's it! He's gonna get it! He's gonna get the kill! The Star Call's not enough, and you messed up! You messed up, Dingus! That is your fault!
He procced that W before he was gonna go in and fight. He did the jump, and as he did the jump, he actually, the W proc ran out.
And then oh, the threshold Treadmaster may die again here. Silent Wafaroo doing a lot of damage. Pander getting the knockup, getting Lamps low, but there's not enough follow-up. Parthogen is trying his damnedest, but it's not gonna get it. A fresh double kill taking that one 2-2-3, the support showing up.
At this point, I'm actually more convinced that all of this is to help keep the Thresh alive to do the carry. Right.
Quite possibly. Oh man, this mid lane tower is going to take a super beating without that Ezreal there to help clear possibly with. Actually, he's not even done with his Iceborne Gauntlet yet. I just automatically assume when I see an Ezreal, he's got a completed Iceborne Gauntlet at the start of the game.
He's got it, man. He's got it. There ain't any other way to play Ezreal.
Treadmaster's here, but I don't think he can do a whole lot in terms of taking this tower way through wise and all. Threshold almost lands. Cho'Gath not able to clear it out, and that is going to be one dead tower. They're not going to follow up with this one. They're just going to write back it on off.
Rift Herald has despawned, so that means the Baron will be spawning here in about 5 seconds. Dragon is still a little bit away from being up, trying to get that third dragon of the game. 5 seconds.
Oh, yeah, that would be a huge one, as they are making tons of rotation. What's funny? Look at that.
It was the Callista. She was trying to take the lantern, and it went away.
Aw.
Yeah, like, so they started walking away.
In before flame.
In before salt.
Barton's in trouble. The flash stun, but he does not arcane shift out in time. He does get a nice little flash duke. Burning the ult from Jax. He thought he had it there, had it back, but he was not quite as quick on it as he wanted to be. Dingus 3-2-0. Farming better than his mid laner.
That ward right above the second tier turret and bot lane 4. Silent Gaming is providing them a good bit of information about who's walking through there, who will be rotating down towards that turret. It's a nice little ward to have out.
Yeah. Vision control actually isn't as strong from Silent as we've seen it past games. That's why this may be a little bit closer. Is this time around, it looks like Good Luck Jonathan's actually got decent enough sight lines in their jungles. Which is really where Silence had most of their success, is in the enemy team's jungle with a very strong ward line all around.
Mm-hmm.
Oh boy, Threshold not quite going to land. Red Panda slowed, but dashing out. And it looks like this inhibitor will be the target of Siege. Silent, as long as they protect this Callista, should be able to take it down pretty quickly, especially with the Jax ult on standby, ready to go there. Not gonna be a hindrance in terms of taking this inhibitor.
It'll be interesting to see if Thresh can manage to
get that. There's the ice support. Missile Bomb stepping out pretty far forward and taking a lot of creep damage, a lot of static damage around there. Treadmaster is hooked up, but that Vayne on one of those. Vayne is coming in. He's gonna probably get the kill on a Missile Bomb. There is the Lulu ultimate to spice things up there. There is the shutdown. Vayne is gonna die though. Parking is gonna get that next kill. Treadmaster on the way to the grave as Silent Lamps is picking it up. Rain takes that one away as the Lulu. And so far it's a 3-for-1. Parthogen and Horcrux Maximus are the surviving members though, so if anyone could hold this, it would be them. Would be is the key phrase there, as Callista has other plans. Absolutely shredding this inhibitor. Lamps is gonna turn out the lights for this one. And Wafflaru gets the blue inhibitor.
That was a very clean fight all around. Dingus went in there. He did a lot of damage to the back line. Dove on the back line really, really hard. Able to take out that Cho'Gath and that Vi very early on in the fight before they could really have that much of an effect on what was going on. Silent Moon did a really good job of staying alive for the rest of those fights and keeping people pretty healthy throughout.
Yep.
Aside from herself.
No, I mean, 2-4 was the score before all of that chaos broke out, so props to Soraka for not dying and ensuring a minimal amount of teammates kick the bucket as well. I think it was only Dingus that fell in that fight.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, he was like up in the middle.
No, I know. Even with the Lulu and the Soraka damage, he just went a little too hard there on what was really only a hook onto the Alistar. So I think they realized that, you know, if each other just threw everything they had at it, they'd probably have more pieces standing at the end. And could really go for that inhibitor checkmate. Trading blow for blow and coming on top. Very aggressive League of Legends play.
Indeed. I think both of these are really good to get these championship games moving on the road. There is an 8.5 cake lead coming out from Silent. They're totally establishing their dominance even quicker than they were before.
Yeah, I don't think we've seen Silent in a lot of Pander. He's gonna go down. Ray is gonna take that one away. Treadmaster is running for his life. And it looks like he will hold on to it, get right away in that one. Ezreal trying to poke out onto the back line in this one, but it looks like Silent is just going to get to walk straight toward that Baron. There is no jungler to contest them. There is nobody telling them they cannot threat. That's why they like to peel on the outside of this one. Does not have the box for that zone, but the play can't keep the enemies out long enough. Ghost Super Long trying to get in there. He gets played back. Definitely gets Silent as well. Silent traded actually back. Dingus is going to kill onto Ghost Super Long. Treadmaster now in a lot of damage. The double kill is coming down for Dingus. Play back, and that's another kill. Rain taking that one. Killing spree. And it looks like Horcrux Maximus, Death Sentence living up to its name, will possibly end the game here.
Yeah, it really depends
on there's the flash.
Gotta
now you gotta walk around anyway. Bam. Bam. W-I-D. Oh boy.
Hey, if you
this is pretty true. But it looks to be a 25-minute victory coming out for the side of Silent. Ironically enough, making some noise in the second half.
Yeah, Thresh going down in there.
Just gotta die to a turret. What's the worst that could happen? GG, WP is coming out.
That was a surprisingly short game coming out of Silent Gaming. After the fight that Good Luck Jonathan put up in the first round, I was expecting to see something a little bit more, but I think Good Luck Jonathan just kind of lost out in the pick ban phase.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Let's get the lights back on in here. I don't like looking like we're in a movie theater.
We are in a movie theater.
Far left.
We're in an Eastbrook's theater. Oh, my eyes.
There we go.
My eyes.
Don't you just love those fluorescents full of life and energy?
Didn't we shout casting lights now?
You can shout cast anything as long as it exists.
For instance, Hall's cough drops.
Heating up. A couple out in the middle there. Maybe they don't have that second line turned up as much energy as it could put into that. That's going to save on the power bill, but cost a little bit in the visibility, maybe making some trips, knocking things over. Not what you want.
This is what happens when you go down to the hardware store with shoutcasters. We just walk in and be like, man, look at this screw.
Rivington changed the game when he shoutcast making a sandwich. Esports were never the same.
Nothing.
God bless that man.
Nothing was ever the same. Man.
No breaks.
No breaks.
On the breakless train. Let's do this.
We are actually a little bit behind schedule if this game is not over in 40 minutes.
Ah, no, we're okay. Sorry, what are they going to do? Kick us out?
Right, yeah. Actually, I think they might.
Nah.
What time are we supposed to be out of here, Trey?
8:30.
Oh. Well, we might be a little behind schedule.
We budgeted finals for 5 hours.
I think we're okay.
Did we really?
Just get into the game.
That's how much Riot does.
Yeah, that's true. Next game. Any closing comments on that game? Because, I mean, it felt like the game pretty much spoke for itself.
Yeah.
There. That was...
No, we were not the voice of that game. More of just...
just kinda... the O's and... Oh, I'm sorry.
We were those kids in the back of the class just, like, throwing paper-wadded balls at everyone who actually tries in school. That's
like,
what we were doing, this kid.
Hey. Oh, come on. You were supposed to do that.
That's why we took the break, Silent Gaming.
Silent Gaming trolling us as usual.
They gave us 15 minutes, like... I can't say that on stream.
But...
we'll just play... Oh, thank you for soldiering through this. You're so brave. The sacrifice you are making on behalf of everybody here is duly noted.
Oh man. It has been a long weekend full of games.
Yeah. To say the least.
We've had a couple of backdoors this weekend, right? Like one or two?
So we had the one, we actually didn't get to see it. It was from A the Mayo when Thrashturbate came in. I know.
What a name.
You know what? Riot can say balls on stream, so...
That's because he's talking about basketballs.
Mm. Two diamonds. Oh, no, wait, diamond two.
Korean solo queue, man. Diamond in Korean solo queue.
Oh man.
Oh man. What?
Tell him
about
Loki sauce.
Oh,
all right. Loki wasn't important last game, but he is this game. Where is Ben, anyway? Is he just running around?
He went home.
He's gone.
So you have to remember his laptop.
Ben has.
No, Cecilia does. Yeah. Cecilia's still here.
She's stuck.
That's right. You have to move it off the screen,
yeah,
Steve.
I
like how Ben only has 3 RP on his account.
I have something ridiculous, like 3 or 6 on mine, too.
Like,
you know how Riot, like, sometimes gives people RP? If you're just like, draw a picture of Lisa and for the extra 3 RP,
oh, yeah.
I want to be like, yeah, you can just, like, take my RP and give it to one of those guys that needs 3 RP.
I'd like to donate my RP.
Yeah, but pretty, an even 0 is fine.
What do you guys think I can get for 105 RP? Probably just like a summoner icon.
Nope. Not even a
summoner.
No.
Oh, my word.
Yeah.
Riot, please. Everything is so expensive. Look at this. I can't even get, like, the oldest icon here.
Pentakill
for 200.
Is Pentakill really prior to Debonair?
Yeah, dude.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, Pentakill is.
Oh, man.
That was when Debonair...
Okay, you know what? Yeah, actually, because Pentakill existed before they actually started doing, like, the songs.
That was when their album came
yeah.
out.
Yeah, when Rito decided to
that was a good album, though.
Get into metal.
Oh, yeah.
That was a good
so
album.
The first 3 songs were
did you not like
vocals,
it?
And the rest was just...
How'd you not like it, Kyle? You were making me really question my shoutcasting duo partner now. First, you say words like moist. You don't like the metal album, that right?
Great word.
I will slap you. Boom.
I already did. Hand slaps coming out in the exchange.
Oh, my God.
It's unbelievable.
Get wrecked, son.
This is unbelievable.
You know what's unbelievable? The fact that Champion Select has not started.
This is madness.
Yo, tell him to sub me in.
What? Sub you in for who?
I don't know. Pick someone.
Probably at this place, at this point in time,
I'll
Red Panda might
anyone.
Be good.
Yeah, go.
That's
literally,
not true
go.
At all. We watched your games. That's not true at all.
Literally, just go ask any of them because we're not the people to ask.
I know, right? No, their teams.
Those are our shirts.
Better than, like, last year's and 2 years ago.
No.
Dude, when
no,
they
those are worse,
jerseys,
dude.
No, those
jerseys.
Are a lot worse. You
yeah.
can't identify who the organizer is.
What do you mean, collegiate organizer?
I don't go around
have
looking at people's
seen their
shirts.
Have you not seen
the
their
other
jerseys?
The other one has a big organizer on the back and
the
front.
The black ones, you mean?
Yeah. Yeah, the white and black ones?
Say yes.
They're like jerseys.
How do you hate those?
Oh,
yeah.
They were.
Yeah.
They look like jerseys.
Oh, yeah, baby.
They weren't actual jerseys, but
hang on.
Oh, Kyle is going rogue. He's making a departure.
Go,
what?
On
what?
Stream.
Oh, what?
He's gonna get
back. Talk about something and then not show it.
Oh,
to
okay.
The lovely 4 viewers.
Dude, I don't even know how many viewers we have
at home.
So these are our collegiate shirts for this year. Last year we had some white ones that looked like referee jerseys from the LCS, if you know what I'm talking about. Personally. I like them both, but Mitch from AGA, who's a filthy quitter, decided that he likes those shirts better than the other ones.
Yeah, to be fair, let's just sit down for a second and focus on the fact that A. The Mayo, team full of silvers, made it further than AGA this tournament.
Oh, shaboom!
You know
got him on a lot.
I want Silent Twin just because he gave me a keyboard.
We actually we have a couple of quick bands coming out. Kindred, Poppy, Dr. Mundo, Vain Shit, and these are all
the
really
yeah the target bands across the board. I think the most potent of these is actually taking Treadmaster off and away from that Poppy. Can't touch that one.
Can't milk these.
Can't
we have
those,
one.
Those.
We should be
correction those.
Check OBS.
Yeah, we live.
Are we streaming?
Yeah.
Streaming fan.
Yeah, you good?
You're the top right now.
Okay.
Squad! What's the Twitch chat saying?
Can I get some 1Gs in the chat?
No one talked about those awesome shirts that we just talked about?
Yeah,
well, Matt Tam, Michael Polo are gods, and no one's talking about
them. Oh.
Damn. Classic Matt Tam and Michael Polo.
Well, I mean, they're working.
Dude,
Tam's just got it, like, going on in the headphones.
Yeah. Lamps over here, picking up the early Ezreal as usual. The Zillion Respect Band coming out, though.
Yeah, didn't want it. Thresh coming through, taking that one away from Waffleroo. Actually, the first time in a while we're seeing Good Luck Jonathan on anything besides Alistair. So
yeah, that's true.
They play Thresh, I think, in the first game we played against them because we took Alistair.
Well, we didn't see that.
But if we didn't expect it.
Never mind, they played Poppy.
So. Oh, yeah, Poppy support. That
there
was
you
good
go,
shit.
Locking in on the Corki again. They say, hey, maybe this time we can make it work.
I mean, they might be able to. Maybe they'll take Corki mid this time. You know, maybe Parthenon will take the Corki mid.
I doubt it.
I don't know, you set a high precedent for the tournament this year.
I did, but they picked it against, they picked AD carry twice. I think it's going to be an Ahri, honestly, depending on the mid lane. Mm.
He did play Ahri yesterday, and that was a pretty good
game. He also played Ahri twice against me.
I'd like to take this point of lull in the stream to remind everybody that all of you are bad, and I am biased against each and every one of you, but particularly Michael Montanaro.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Worst player in the tournament. No. Worst player in life. GG, son.
Can you just...
Hang on, we're asking our outside sources. Michael Montanaro, worst today confirmed.
Oh, yes. My God.
Confirmed. 100%. Mitch Williams.
Oh, my God. Make it stop.
I don't even know who that is.
Don't worry about it.
I am just...
Don't worry about it.
You are just...
Salt shaking.
You are just so salt right now, dude. Like...
Big fat noob.
I wonder if our approach to that criticism, which I actually feel was relatively accurate because we are kind of mean to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
I think what we should do is in response to that criticism, we should literally just wreck everyone.
Right.
Everybody.
No, it's
like
game
Silent
two.
Moon,
game two was particularly savage for a reason.
Like Silent Moon
calling
man.
Out Dingus on the stream.
Yeah,
he's gonna be salty about that one.
Has to pick Jesus.
Yeah, dude. That's what Silent Moon does. Can't play real champions. Pick Soraka.
Hey, works well enough for him.
I don't see
any other teams in this. I don't see any.
He gets carried by Dingus.
No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, I think his Galio play more enough proved.
I don't think we're ever gonna be able to stream anything for the Georgia Collegiate Series.
The advantage to nobody watching this is nobody's watching it.
There's the Ahri pick. Look, I told you.
The Ahri pick is kind of Silent Moon. I swear to God, if you pick that freaking
the Soraka disrespect again.
No, dude. See what he can do. He can always take Blitzcrank mid. That's
now, there's
more,
the Galio.
That's more reasonable, right?
Loki sauce is Ben, otherwise known
he's
as
Ben,
that guy.
One.
Oh, he's the dude's laptop we're using.
Okay, he just said the Twitch
chat.
Caster Bias GG.
Caster Bias GG. The only winners of this tournament are us, the casters.
It's true, we are the only winners, excluding my scratchy throat. Which? Halls.
Sponsored here on
Halls. Halls. Cough drops.
Oh my God.
Ooh! Halls. Zerath. That'd be neat.
Zerath.
Zerath.
Srath.
Kasurath. Wait, it'd be like
I wonder
if he's
locking
Kurath. Galio. He's actually going to lock in Xerath. Oh, I think he heard our criticism about not playing a real champion and only cheese, and he's playing Xerath.
Good.
All right, listen, find me somebody who has
wait,
any form of mobility. Moon, play somebody that can move. All of your casters, like you just play AP casters that rely on Flash to get out of every single instance.
On standing still and hoping you don't die.
Yeah, that's entirely like play from the back line with an AP caster. You've literally not played anyone with any form of escape or mobility.
Soraka?
Right.
Not. Doesn't have one.
Morgana.
Galio. Doesn't
Karma.
Have one. Morgana.
Galio.
Galio.
Lux.
Lux.
That
Lux
was
the big
one.
One.
Yeah, that
he
was
just
the
like derping around the mid lane getting caught out by Shaco.
If you play Brand next game.
What are you doing?
Oh man. Which bar? The chat bar?
Yeah, I wanna see the chat.
Oh, move it. You have to move it back to the.
Oh, you have to move it back to the other screen.
Yeah, to the
yeah,
left.
You do.
Can't say that on stream, Mitch. We may be savage, but we're not barbaric.
That's right. Thank you. Thank you,
but
Kyle.
Barbarians are savage.
No, that's not true.
You ever see Dave the Barbarian?
Scientific
fact.
That show was awesome.
How about some anthropological studies?
Best here. Best okay. Moment of that show. Hi, most of you are probably wondering why I tied a squirrel to a megaphone. Well, goodbye.
All right.
What happened to that show?
Thinking quickly, using nothing but a squirrel, some string, and a megaphone, he quickly constructs a megaphone.
No one saw it coming, GG.
That show was the best, dude.
What network was that on? Was that Nickelodeon? No. Disney? Was that Disney?
I think it was Disney.
Dude, I don't know.
I think it was Disney. What chat are you trying to bring up, dog? This is the last
game. He did pick Trendemir.
He did pick Trendemir. This is...
That happened while
dude,
I was
giving
like...
the knowledge. Oh lay down the knowledge.
Yeah, dude.
go run into the...
Speaking of knowledge, here in my garage.
Go run in, but yo, dude, this is what you do in Trendemir.
Drop the knowledge. Just press E.
You know what I think is more valuable than my diamond border?
I said no way.
What diamond border, Kyle? You're in bronze one.
GG. I am in bronze one.
Those 8-2 placements got you super far.
What a nude caster.
Oh my god.
I was going 5 last season, and now I'm bronze one with a winning record in placements.
I mean, he went
8-2 and got placed in bronze one.
Bronze one.
It was 6-4.
Oh, was it really?
Yeah.
You lied?
No, I maintained 6-4. You remembered incorrectly.
I thought you said 8-2.
Nope.
Oh, 6-4. I mean, maybe bronze one a little bit.
That's still a winning record.
It is. I feel like it shouldn't drop you that far, though.
I was expecting, like, silver 3.
Dude, that's what happened to me. I went silver. I was silver 5.
You ended plat last season.
It's true, I did end in plat. I was plat 5. The climb.
He's really good at this game.
I am. Well, based on my analysis, you wouldn't know.
Yeah, dude, he ended up.
No spoilers, Ben.
Ben actually spoiled Star Wars.
Yeah, he spoiled it yesterday.
Yesterday in chat.
And I gave him the ban.
Ban him.
It's only been a month.
Get over it.
Someone spoiled it the day it came out for me.
It's still in theaters.
Like, 4 weeks.
I was like, dude, you're a dick. I was like, dude, you're a dick for doing that. You're like 24, you know better. He's like, I don't even know if those are true or not. I'm like, that's a fucking lie.
Here's the big one.
Hey, you're not allowed to say that.
On 4chan, about a couple days before the movie came out, it actually someone posted a GIF of the critical spoiler just before the movie even came out.
Wow.
Like, how do you know that?
Because
I thought the internet was safe.
The internet's never
4chan
safe.
4chan is safe for everybody. I recommend going there.
What is it? There was a...
Kennesaw State brought to you by www.4chan.org/b/.
Please never.
Actually, there's a big thing.
For a halt.
Control F trap.
There's a big article in, I think it might have been Business Week or something, about how Pornhub was having to, like, pull down a bunch of videos because they were Star Wars spoilers. Yeah, because people would post the spoilers there, and they would have to pull the videos down. God.
Did you know that One Punch Man episode 12 is hosted on Pornhub?
it's just like what?
In the world during the World Cup, they had to start mass takedowns of Germany beating Brazil 7-1 because people just kept uploading it under like just rough,
like hardcore.
Oh boy. No. No.
Is that even a section of Pornhub? I don't know.
Rough.
I think Tumblr over here in the corner is just looking to find out where it doesn't exist.
I know, right?
Oh boy.
Oh my god.
I thought this was a League of Legends tournament. It just turned into us sitting here.
If you play again, your teammate should be the Tumblr tryhards.
Yeah.
I actually blame our little audience around here.
I think
we would have stayed well enough on topic if it weren't for the interruptions.
Yeah, probably.
What are the chances that Trindamere dumpsters joke?
Approximately
95%.
You say 95%, but you didn't share the secrets, dude.
What are the secrets? I'll go play for them right now.
All right. Trindamere actually has a pretty easy path.
If he loses,
this
wins.
I'm going to ping out here on the map exactly how Trindamere can get.
I don't think you can.
The pings aren't working. No, they were working yesterday.
No, they weren't.
Yeah, you can ping from spectator mode.
Ping on yours?
Yeah.
I didn't ping on mine.
I did it several times.
You're a liar.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, look at that. Oh, I'm a liar.
You are a liar. It's alt, dude.
Hey,
it's alt.
It's alt. Okay. It's control on mine.
Did you ever figure out when Trick played for...
I did not.
You know,
I couldn't find anything on the internet.
It wasn't Trick 2G, Mr. Liar.
Okay, maybe it was Trick's... I did find out they announced him as an analyst. Anyway, this is the Trindamere Path to Platinum.
Platinum.
It's very cute. You start here,
and you
push, and just keep pushing to here, and you will eventually find platinum. No, because that's when the Trindamere strat stops working.
I'm pretty sure it would still work.
Your mileage may vary, but
go.
That's how Mitch capped out at platinum.
You only capped out at platinum.
Cho'Gath did get a. Cho'Gath is winning the game with one full CS right now.
Speaking of shots, we're gonna see how many silent lamps can miss in one game.
Shaboom!
Currently 1-1, but we'll be watching your career with great interest.
I want these people to go.
Dude, Parthagin is off to a great start. Missing all of that CS. Yeah, we did.
It was game four.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, it was four games.
That was great. Yeah, I didn't cast the last one.
Oh, there it is. Tread Master getting hit up by that Braum. Passive has to get the play just to pop him back.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
oh
yeah.
Baby. There
that
it is.
Crit. That crit was disgusting.
All
I planned
skill.
It. I planned
just
it.
He's just a better player.
Yeah, if we're trying to get really savage, Silent Rain, you're bad. Gosu T-Bomb, you're bad. It's just a matter of who's more bad.
No. Who's less bad?
No. Who's more bad?
Who's bad?
We only keep it down.
Right, we don't grade anybody on a slightly positively inferred scale here. Everyone is trash. The most trash. The trashest of the game.
I feel like there's like trash and unrecyclables. You know, because both are garbage, right? But one is salvageable.
One is useful.
A fun fact, Chick-fil-A cup.
Actually, you burn more energy, like, doing recyclables than you do, like save, like, for some more.
You actually burn more energy posting dank memes than you do reading dank memes.
It's true.
That's Sonic.
I don't know why. I'm a big fan of the dank memes.
Silent Rain,
just
take what are you trying to do, man?
He's trying to set the...
Oh, my. Oh, we got a gank coming in.
Man, Gosu T-Bomb. He is getting absolutely destroyed as Dingus drops an A-bomb right on his face. Absolutely nuked. Gone. Dunzo.
Did I really need to clarify that?
I don't know.
Waffleroo with that nice little fancy feet.
Can't say those things on stream, man.
Hey, Cecilia set the bar today.
With what?
Cecilia said not to worry about it today.
Oh, she did.
What did Cecilia say on stream?
Well, I can't say it because we're on stream.
Yeah, we have standards.
I'm not baited as easily as the members of Good Luck Jonathan. Thank you very much.
Oh my god. Actually, I feel like it should go the other way. Silent Gaming is the one that has gotten gimped at level 2 and in level 1.
That is true, actually.
So would you say that?
You are losing the bait war to the people you are baiting in turn, Silent Gaming.
No, because that Thrasher bait's not on their team, obviously.
The Silver Force Ever.
Oh,
man.
Part of the is getting caught, mate. Getting caught, mate. I feel like Ari's going to win that match at level 6.
Oh, man. Good hook onto Lamps. Can we knock the lamp off the shelf and break it? No. Not going to be the case there. As the teleport is coming down. Horcrux Maximus is so dead here. Silent Rain having to come into somebody else's lane just to get the kills.
Nice fancy feet.
Can't do it on his own.
Lorraine didn't hit a kill.
But he did get an assist.
Which is the most useful he's going to be all game.
Oh shit, shots fired.
Just throwing it down, everyone's bad.
Oh.
We'll see.
Oh!
It's Silent Moon!
He outplayed himself!
Can't get the kill on to Parthogen.
Go Lee Sin.
Dude, I think
man, and there's the flash out! Scared of the Braum!
I think that's why Silent Moon plays champions that have, like, no mobility besides Flash. You have, like, a smaller chance of outplaying yourself like Ahri.
That's genius.
Yeah, it's true, yeah. Limit your tools.
Limit the tools to outplay yourself.
And your potential of throwing
increases
is so much harder with little T-Rex arms.
I've got such a big head but tiny little arms. Literally every T-Rex.
Oh, man. It already is 3-0, actually.
Yeah.
Oh!
Come out. Evenly distributed enough across the board.
You just said it was 5.
I said I wanted 5 games. No, I want 5 games. It's going to be a 3-0.
We are seeing...
I'm not going to lie to the viewers.
You're not allowed to make predictions like that. You got to keep it middle of the road.
Yeah, you always
it's
going to
be a hard-fought battle this game, but it's going to be a close 3-0.
What are you doing?
You can't see.
Snape kills Dumbledore.
Whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa! Haven't gotten around to seeing the movie yet.
Oh, here we go. Red Panda coming in.
Coming in, trying to get the kill. Silent Rain getting the good knockup on T-Bomb. Calling him a chicken.
He missed a stationary target.
No, he was moving that time.
Oh boy, Waffleroo gonna get down onto Pathogen. Pathogen
is?
Good taunt.
He's gonna live.
Charming it out, having it all away. Here we
oh.
go.
The ward coverage from Red Silent Gaming is incredible.
Red Pander. Actually taking a page
knocked
out of the book.
What was
out
that?
Of Silent Dingus.
Nah, man. Sometimes you just gotta knock him out.
I hope he, why are they not killing
what?
Him? What?
My job.
And so here we have a fascinating case of, in the wild, mistakes were made. They just let him go. It was good. They did. They caught the fish, and they're like, I don't want this right now. We'll come back later.
You think Treadmaster would be playing a better Thresh after getting some hard lessons from Waffleroo?
Waffleroo taking it.
Missing all the hooks. Any hook you can throw out, just hit whatever. Almost killed Lamps that one time we died.
I'm just saying, I really want to see Waffleroo, like, I want to see him ult and see where it goes. Like, does it hit people? Does it miss people? Because technically...
Oh my goodness, boy, from the back, that Dingus pick up the buy has been so crucial for their success.
Nice pull up.
Silent Moon, trying to decide if he wants to do a little something over there at the blue buy. As it
I
looks
think
out.
If Red Pando is running like Braum, there's no chance he's gonna stick around and Zeref and Vi show their faces.
Why did Vi?
Man, Ezreal don't mean it.
Because the blue one is.
Oh! Ghost Bomb going in on Silent Rain.
This team farm. This communication.
First Dragon is about to come out for Silent Gaming. No contest from the Lee Sin.
He doesn't do any damage.
Doesn't do any damage, but Rain's putting down the slammage.
Really? You're killing me, dude. Did you see what Ben said in the chat? Is Lee lagging?
Oh, man. We're all on the same internet here, guys.
So, yes, that means he is lagging.
Oh,
yeah,
boy.
That's right. What a hook.
What a cue.
Oh, Tread Master. Master of treading the needle.
Oh! Silent Waffle Roo. Silent Waffle Roo is missing those Winter's Bites, which I feel like is fair to both sides. it makes them equal.
Yeah.
Got Lamp that time.
Nice! He's gonna go in on it! Probably ill advised, but you do what you gotta do as he gets in with the Ignite coming down. He's taking a lot of damage. Horcrux matching the stun up by the concussive blows. Winter's Bite is gonna finish that one off, and the exhaust is coming down. He's gonna have to get the Thresh Blade to get out. Can Ezreal do anything out of this one? I don't think so. The teleport's coming in from the back, though. They may have baited them there. That's a great hook! The one that lands is the one that counts, and Silent Lamps is down.
Really interesting teleport by Ghostsuit T-Bomb. Arjun getting hit in half health, one combo.
And Ezreal
can
oh man.
Oh,
it sucks.
That's not how you say it. You say it. He missed all of his shots. He whiffed them all because Ahri burned her ultimate to dodge them all.
Oh, man.
You have to give them both credit.
No. None of them get credit.
I don't.
Like, Xerath just happened to miss them, and Ahri is just running around like a helmet.
Isn't that how you play Xerath? Are you just, like, shoot your ult and hope to hit somebody?
No. Aiming.
Are you sure? Nah, dude, those are masterful.
Happy feet. Wombo combo.
Matic Falco!
Matic Falco! Oh! Oh! Oh, where are you at? Where are you at?
We should have used that for the Shaco combo.
Oh, man. Shaco was turning that up.
Yeah, that Shaco Orianna combo was good. If you guys haven't seen that game, you should go back and watch it. It's.
It will be.
No. It's on Twitch, though. It's on Twitch. Twitch records the matches for 2 weeks. Keep it. Yeah.
Man.
Our Twitch has a bunch of viewers, though.
Oh, yeah.
Up top.
Oh,
there we go. Just hold still.
45.
I'll do the old moves.
Going up the layer, Rain, please come save me. We're supposed to do this together, right? Silent Rain. Come
hey,
again.
I called
Braum
it.
Ult. Braum ult.
Braum ult.
Doesn't hit anything.
But I mean, yesterday's not found either.
It should be. It's alright, Kyle's got copies. It'll be over.
I
don't
know why. The first two. Everything.
It's alright, Kyle.
This thing at this point solely consists of members of Silent ghosting it.
There we go.
It has to be it. I ghost it so I can hear people commentate on how good I am.
Oh, are you talking about when I said Mordecai is probably the worst person on their team right now?
Oh man, Wampu just keeps eating hook after hook, and they're going in on it. Can they get the kill? No! Red Panda is going to be the first one to fall. Dingus gets that one down. Going to get the kill, but meanwhile, Trendemir executing the Platinum strategy. Ignore team, acquire towers.
I'm confident that is the only strategy for Trendemir.
The only one that matters, anyway.
That's right.
It's true.
Out here in the bot lane. Silent Moon looking to quietly eclipse his lane opponent of Ahri.
Beating her by 33 CS, a kill, and an assist. The gold differential there is quite large, almost 2,000 gold difference between Zera and Ahri.
That's a bad situation to be in.
The only gold that's in favor of.
Good luck, Jonathan.
Of good luck, Jonathan. It's Trendemir.
No, support gold.
Yeah, support gold and Trendemir.
Thresh is up on the bomb.
Because that kill.
Because of that kill.
Shade.
It was after that
16.
Oh, man.
Steven, go subtly brag somewhere else.
Hashtag humble brag.
I played it a few times. I don't know what team he was on.
Carthage playing so poorly, his team made him go bottom. Gonna pick up on that Rift Herald around 14 minutes into the game. The only way you can counteract this split pushing strategy in the Trendemir is to have minions with you. Oh, Thresh going actually pretty hard on these hooks. Braum hits the Glacial Fissure when his target has nowhere else to run, and it is Pulse Fire Ezreal. Slamming it down. There's the turret going down. That's the second one he's taken away. Fourth turret, overall for the side of Silent Gaming. This looks actually a lot more like a Trendemir game now that he's lost his two inner turrets.
The problem is right now he's grouping his team.
Oh boy, Dean's going in hard on the part of him, getting the good trail on, but now he's deep in enemy territory. Behind the line, no good down. That is going to be the kill coming out. For Corki, the Braum passive might proc here. Double kill onto that Cho'Gath. Wrist Herald is gone. Lee Sin from the back onto Lamps. The Summoner Heal does come out, but now he is taking those concussive blows straight to the face. Two more, one more. Not going to matter. As Silent is going to walk right out. Head back to just sieging this turret. A little tired to play the game. Well behind the entirety of the enemy base. Lamps. Pressure down on these staffers, just taking them left, right, and center, literally.
That
in
Ahri,
every single lane, he's taking a turret.
The Ahri's going for the greed build, too, picking up the Dark Seal, even though she doesn't have a kill yet.
He starts with that.
Is he really?
He did against me.
Apparently, he starts with the Dark Seal. The greed build right off the bat.
That is a goal to run the greed build.
Have mercy on Soraka.
That is true, actually. Soraka didn't explode.
Is it really?
Yeah,
I guess
when it's
the
fans.
Yeah, me either. I feel like that's the most overlooked trait of it.
Oh man, Thresh flashing out.
Everybody having to sit there and dodge silent.
Yeah.
So
bad, Silent Lamps now will be able to take towers even faster with that minion wave after that.
Dude, in the, what was it? Lucky in the Wards? Lucky GB took a GB rap for them.
Oh man, Braum is just eating everything. Wafflu has not yet dodged a skill shot.
I played a game.
Why bother dodging when you can block?
Yeah, that's true. When you can just have a big ass shield.
He's dodging it with his face.
I played a game where we had a permanent banner of command. And he took both towers.
It's no good on
him. He took, like, both towers.
For that, I'll tell that AP game.
Yeah, and also
because it has to use AB only.
Hook came close to
and
hitting
then, like,
moon.
Stack it up with turrets.
Oh yeah.
It was a funny story.
I feel like that'd be really annoying to play against.
I mean, Harbinger is annoying in general.
Do you guys ever see? I don't know if we have any anime games around. Naruto.
Yeah, dude.
Back in the Chunin Trials when Rock Lee is fighting Gaara. And basically it just like drops those leg weights and suddenly becomes this like too fast to catch. I feel like that's kind of where Silent Moon is right now. Just on any champion that can usually have some form of dodge with. Just looking at him dodge that thresh hook like it wasn't even there. So seamlessly just flicked back with the reaction time. Because he was on a collision course for that thing and then he's just like, swerve. Not going to happen, Thresh. Not no
season. Also,
Goku
and
Well, Goku was a little bit different because he spent all the time in the increased gravity chamber.
I mean,
but
Oh my god. Gets just the
holy cow, he's actually turning it around. Look at that! Gonna get the kill on the Wobbler 2, perhaps. Nope.
Oh, turned close. Turner making the turnaround. Going 2-2-2 now.
Vendemir doing his best Napoleon cosplay at the Battle of Wobbler.
Oh, I saw you.
Why?
I don't know. I'm out of material.
I know, I am too. 2 days of seeing the same champions over and over again.
We've seen this game five times already, ladies and gentlemen. This is drier than SK Telecom's first series against Royal Club.
Oh, my heart.
Played in the Sahara Desert.
Oh, my heart.
This game's technically bloody, too.
17 kills in 19 minutes. Come on, with anime. We've seen more. We've seen more. No, we don't.
No, we don't. That's just
we don't use any. We don't use any words that aren't in the Bible.
Never once.
Can't prove it.
Challenge accepted.
I have executive authority.
I have executive authority. Dude, anybody else excited for Bayonetta to come out on Super Smash?
No.
I have never played Bayonetta. But maybe you, Brian.
I love that game. All right.
One person out of the whole.
I feel like people only still like treat Smash as that one friend from your old neighborhood that got really weird, but like you all have history, so you're not really just gonna like drop it like that. It's like, okay, you grew up together, so it's sort of there's still something there, but it really hasn't been fun for either of you in a while. That's Smash. Speaking of Smash, Dead Smash is about to get Smash. Here I know it's gonna come down. Silent Moon on the Rampage actually gets a little bit of a splash.
This is a good shot, Spy. Silent Moon, finally landing some of those skill shots this game. Actually, just kidding.
Fine.
I was gonna say, I think Silent Moon has been the most consistent in terms of landing skill shots.
Once he got warmed up, it's just been going.
Yeah,
true.
Sure.
So every time you say something about
and before Jin Min,
you just turn into this big bowl of salt that's overflowing.
Oh my word.
Oh boy. Well, that's the unbag rate. The bomb just close. Actually gonna keep him locked up for the duration of it. Xerath cannot finish it off. The charm will not land the hook neither. It is not looking good. Silent Lance is gonna get that kill. I believe with the downtown Ezreal ult, but I didn't quite see what he pulled off. What else was on that cooldown?
That charm actually did hit Silent Moon, but he cleansed it instantly.
That's gonna be the shutdown denying that. is the start of it, ladies and gentlemen. The reverse sweep coming at you live
from the KSU Esports Club.
Oh man. Yeah, that would be.
I feel like if I had bowling or league right now, I'd go bowling.
Could you imagine if Good Luck Jonathan reverse swept, brought it back, won the game, and then like we just had to live with the fact that the game leading up to a reverse sweep was this insecure.
I would feel terrible.
Oh man.
I would actually take the next game before we're
here. Oh my goodness, God. It's happening! The prophecy is being fulfilled! The Silent Raid is going to go down! The double kill, the turnaround, but their Nexus is getting wailed on by minions. The new wave has spawned. Are they going to make it back? I think so! Oh, ladies and gentlemen, this is so turned. The hour is upon us. Moon shall be eclipsed.
Oh no!
Rain will fall. Lamps will be overshadowed. I don't have anything for Dingles or Wopplaroo. Get better names, you guys. Oh boy. They're gonna go back and watch this, and they're just gonna hate us.
They really are. At least it's only this game, though, right?
No, it was second game too.
Second game wasn't nearly as bad.
Second game was
really as bad.
Yeah.
This was terrible. This game was. I am not ever going to say I shoutcast this game.
Oh my goodness, not like.
I will not claim it.
Yeah, no one's ever gonna find out about this.
What's that?
No, yeah, this is just closer to live commentary. This is the director's cut of the Kennesaw State Esports Tournament.
This is what we sound like behind the scenes, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh my goodness. If you want to know our opinions.
What do you mean?
Nice smite, Silent Dingus.
Just jump right in on it.
A different Braum. Oh, yeah, a different Braum. This is legit.
It's not blind pick, despite the fact that nobody's watching.
You actually did hit a stationary target.
You held on to that. I can't tell whether you thought it was funny or you're holding it against me, but either way.
I feel like it's some of both. Lamb's getting hit, putting out the BM with the back animation.
Oh, man.
All three lanes are collapsing down on top of Good Luck Jonathan. It looks like this very well could be the end. Goes to T-Bomb getting knocked out. Maybe getting his ult off.
Silent Gaming literally so bad they need to the bear and make this happen.
Oh, my God, my heart. Hashtag cold blood, hashtag savage, hashtag not blessed.
Triple kill for Vi! Ezreal gonna take that one away, denying the penta quadra kill! And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, Silent Gaming, all year 2015, League of Legends, 16, I'm sorry, yeah.
Well,
this,
technically,
it's only because this was supposed to happen last year, administrative staff.
My bad, that's on me.
More shots fired.
Thank
if
you.
I'm going down, you're all coming with me.
Thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you had a good time.
Champions by technical disqualification.
There is no technical disqualification involved here. Thank you for watching, everybody. We'll see you in about a month or two when we have more tournaments. Thank you, everybody. And this is Brian Starkey signing off with Kyle Crow, who is, in fact, probably the worst caster I've ever seen.
No doubt.
Farewell, ladies and gentlemen.